Northline with my left-hand man, because he always sits on my left-hand side, Josh Sampson. Good evening to you as the sun sets on another beautiful day here in the Top End.
Yeah, good evening to you, Edo. Good evening to everyone joining us on Tats Thunder Vision this evening. And, yeah, you're seeing the future of territory footy right here. There's no doubt about that. Northline Oval here in Palmerston, a multi-million dollar redevelopment. Fantastic facility, all brand spanking new and ready to go. The ground is as flat as we went out there before and had a bit of a look. And, this is great for territory footy. This is great for, at a time as well when, of course, the Darwin Buffaloes were announced that they'd be coming out to Palmerston during the week as well. So as the Thunder Boys make their way onto the ground, all of a sudden they've got a lot to play for tonight.
They do, don't they? Yeah. Sydney Swans had to knock off the Brisbane Lions reserves. It's the Sydney Swans reserves and the Brisbane Lions reserves. They're battling it out against each other. One of the AFL sides in Brisbane is not playing finals in the AFL senior competition this year, but the Swans are, and they're going gung-ho to make sure that they've got a full squad ready to go and go deep into September. Whereas the Lions, well, we don't know how fully fledged they were going at it. Obviously, they've all got to combine for a pre-season squad, and Michael Voss would be dictating what's going on there. But nonetheless, it was the Sydney Swans that got over the line today in a cross-conference battle, which means that if the Thunder win tonight, they sneak into that top spot and they get a rest next week in the first week of finals, which is probably exactly what Archer would like.
Yeah, I think he would too. And look, for the last couple of weeks, as the Lights just making their way on here and the Bombers are coming out, it rather does change the dynamic, I think, of the way the Thunder's been preparing. But to this point, it's been about making sure that they get that second spot, that chance for the home final, the double chance. And now, I'm sure that they'll keep doing things to the same level they have been, but now it's something a little bit different for them. And then if they can get a week off, they'll come up against a Brisbane side who no doubt will be cherry ripe and looking to bounce back in the second semi-final. So, look, but that's the thing. They've still got to win the game. Redland have had a very, very good finish to the season. I think they were 1-4 or 1-5 at one stage, so they have finished the season very, very strongly.
Yeah, look, they were struggling at the start of the year, but they've really clustered some games together. And make no bones about it, this side's to be reckoned with. Yeah. They're fourth on the table. They won't go anywhere, whether they win or lose tonight. And some great news with their coach, Greg Seaton Lonsdale, signing on for another couple of years, which is giving them some stability, obviously, in the number one rank as coach. And look, this is a side that have rested a couple of players going into it. No Pullman out here tonight. We were expecting him to get off the plane and strut his stuff tonight, but obviously they've got bigger fish to fry next week.
Yep.
And they're gearing themselves up, and whether it'll be Gold Coast or all the likes there in that bottom half of that five, we'll wait and see. But this should be an interesting game nonetheless. Not saying that either side will be going as half-hearted. You were mentioning off-air earlier that the Thunder Boys were working on their stoppage work during training this week. So I think it's going to be a tight and tough affair. Although this ground reminds me now, for all the Victorian listeners out there or whoever ventured out to Waverley Park back in the day or VFL Park back in the day, This ground is reminding me of the surface. It's plush, it's lush, and also that half the grandstands are missing. There's only a couple of grandstands here, and then the rest is just an open field, and that's what the Hawthorn Football Club train on at the moment. There's now a suburb that has burst out of nowhere and surrounding that ground. But if wind is to play any sort of factor in this game, it'll be going across the face of ground tonight. So it won't be going from goal to goal line. It'll be going along the wing. So that'll be something interesting to have a look at. More great reason to get excited about tonight is Darren Ewan kicked 6 goals last week. So he's up and about. I had a chat to him at the documentary launch of Northern Lights earlier in the week, which was a year in review, so to speak, about 2011 in the dual premierships that the Thunder won. And he's smiling. He's like a little Cheshire cat at the moment, so he's starting to get into some form ahead of the big occasion over the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, he certainly seemed to have found his mojo in the last couple, and yeah, by all reports he did. He had an absolute day out against Morningside last weekend, and yeah, look, he's been in the media a fair bit up here, and yeah, he just sounds really cheerful, and he's always smiling, and has got plenty to say and to have a laugh. So, you know, and as I said, we've mentioned before, and it is true, that he is a little bit of a confidence player.
Yep.
So, look, if he can get a couple under his belt scored early, that could set him up for a really good night and hopefully for another victory. And just on Northern Lights, you and I went and had a look at that at Birch Carroll and Coyle on Tuesday night, or Wednesday night, I think it was. But
yep.
It was absolutely fantastic.
Awesome.
It really did exceed our expectations. It was fantastically shot. It showed not only what Thunder's been doing on the field, but the really hard work and the great work that AFL NT staff and NT Thunder staff have been doing off the field as well. I get asked a lot, being from Adelaide and you being from Melbourne, what exactly goes on?
Mm.
What's the reason? What's the point with NT Thunder and Territory Footy? And, you know, from what we saw, that's exactly what the point. So hopefully you can get around Australia and we can show that Territory Footy is a great product, and in remote and regional centres, it's never been more alive.
Now, how's this game going to go tonight? I mean, obviously, we look at the big fella up forward from both the lines. You look at Darren Ewing at one end and Clouston down the other for the Bombers. You think it's just going to be a shootout in some respects. Earlier on in the year, the Thunder did it quite easily in the end.
Yep.
Redland stuck with them with a couple of quarters there, and that's what most sides have been doing with the Thunder this year, unless they've been playing them in Alice, where they've been getting a win. But at the same time, they've been going with them for three quarters, and then they're fast finishes as well, the Thunder. How do Redland combat that, especially on a wide open ground like this?
Well, I think that's probably the thing, is because the ground is so wide, and Thunder love going pretty much the from coast to coast down the guts, the great journey home. So if they can maybe force Thunder into a situation where they can push the zone and spread the zone as wide as they can, that might get Thunder out of their comfort zone a little bit. And if they can play the flanks, bottle it in from there, it will be tough and tight early in this breeze, which we talk about. So if they can bottle it in early in the flanks and then work it back their way through there, then they stand a really good chance of winning this game tonight and getting Thunder on the hop early.
Having a look at the bench there for the Thunder, Vassell, Anderson, Pryor, McEwen and Smith starting on the bench there, and expect that not to really take much of effect, really, because the interchanges nowadays, I mean, Steve Johnson started on the bench on Friday night for the Cats and he was on in 2 seconds, so,
yeah,
you know,
right.
Going to the bench nowadays, it doesn't mean anything, it just means, well, you're in that position, really. It's pretty much another position on the ground nowadays. I mean, and it plays such a vital part in games as well. You see the switch of play and they use the interchange and off they go again.
Yep.
I will say this, though, if you do go around the wings here at Northline Oval, you might get jet lag because you will have, you seriously will have gone around the Cape to get to goal tonight. So it'll be interesting which side actually tries to pinpoint their kicks all the way up, because it is like Subiaco, it is like Waverley Park.
Yeah.
Big ground here, and I tell you what, there's going to be a fair bit of mileage in the feet tonight, so will be interesting. Perfect conditions underfoot, currently 26 degrees outside, sun setting again, and we're ready for another big clash of NEAFL Northern Conference football, the best of the rest, you would have to say.
Yeah.
And we can't wait for this one to get underway, as the umpire is preparing to get underway. Holds the ball off. Phil Carr and Cameron Islett next to each other, the two captains. And away we go. Vernicone wins the tap out that time. Slipping and sliding all over the place. There were some of the Bombers players and still trying to find themselves, and a free kick going the way of the Bombers. This time it is going the way that time of Page. He moves it on. Well, just trying to find an option. And this is what we're talking about. He's going along the wing. Find mark taken there by Rees. So Rees starting to link up. Heading in the Clouston direction. Had to work hard there against Tapp. It's body-on-body stuff. Deep and very close to the fence here. And that's what someone's got to be worrying about tonight, especially there with Sondergeld, as he got smashed into the fence. Fences are quite close to the boundary line. As the ball gets thrown in again, deep in the Redland Bombers forward pocket. Tapp wins it out this time. Goes underneath there is Rosier, the little terrier, trying to get it out. Clouston on top of him, just trying to tunnel it out. Taps underneath it as well. And the umpire will come in and ball it up. So only been going just on a minute in this first quarter. No score as yet. Tapp and Clouston will do the ruck work. Tapp down that time there by Clouston. Links up with Sondergeld. Rosier Sharks at that time. Under pressure at the moment are the Thunder in defence. The weapon goes on top. That's Nathan Brown. Cass is in there as well, along with Bieske. And will be thrown up again. So this is the stoppage work we were talking about earlier, Josh.
So the rucks to go at it again. Clouston and Tapp. One down by Clouston. Free kick pushed out for the umpire here. Yeah, a little bit of a push out there. Good call against Sean Tapp. So Clouston lining up just outside 50. We was talking off air as well. Wonder if the 50s are maybe just a little bit short at either end. So no breeze to speak of thus far. And a very important kick here to get him off to a flying start. as Clouston now approaches. Kick on its way. It's a bit of a floater, and it's floated through for one behind. So they're on the board first, and as we mentioned, they've been working the flanks. They're one behind. Thunder are yet to score. 2 minutes gone here at North Lines.
So Jason Rowe to kick in for the Thunder. A big booming kick that he is. Goes about 60-odd metres. A wonderful kick indeed, and spots up, and away go the Thunder through Rosier. They've got a link up, slipping and sliding all over the place. You'll need the Grass Cats on tonight, lads, as the Bombers start to make their way back in forward. A little bit of an Aussie Jones kick, and he had nowhere to go to that time. That's how errant the kick was that time. And 50 metres going against Sondergeld. So Jason Rowe has got the whole field to have a look at the moment. His players are matched up all over the ground. It's hard to be a zoned out of defence tonight, you would think. It'd be man-on-man football all over the ground. We're going to have to work hard. Missing his chance there was Cossack. Taken high, maybe. Go again, it goes Cossack. Find some space. Geez, he did that well. And trying to link up there with Lockwood. Farrah goes for it. And away go the Bombers again. So the Thunder just trying to get used to the conditions here at the moment. It is like a billiard table. And here comes Bilski. Fired mark, 55 metres out. So Jason Rowe's going to have his work cut out with this youngster. Kicked a couple of goals against the Thunder last time. And they're starting to find the holes. And a mark is being paid there to Rees. It's on a 45-degree angle, and he'll kick from right on 50.
So Rees now look just assessing his options here. I reckon he'd probably be best served to go and have a shot. There's nobody in the goal square.
Well, that's what I thought he was going to do. Yeah. But it looks like he's looking for options as well. Now, here he goes. He'll line this one out. Need his best kick. He keeps it low, though. Sprays it a little bit. No one really on the last line defence. It was just Lachlan Argus down there, along with the man in Pringle, the potato chip himself. And the ball will be thrown in deep in the forward pocket for the Redland Bombers. So hasn't even made it into the forward 50 there for the Thunder as yet. As Tap taps it down. Danger signs here for the Thunder as only metres out from goal. Smith gives it off. Oh, Heenan was held on to, but they missed that one. Great work there by Webster to shark that one. Argus, little chip kick into space. Vassell's going to have to work hard. Phil Cast is there as well for the Bombers. They're under pressure at the moment, both sides. They're hemmed up on the boundary line. 70 metres out from Redland's attacking 50 as the ball scoots along over the boundary line, and Sondergeld sees it over the line, will be thrown up 80 metres out from Redland's goal.
So 4.5 going here at Northline Oval. Again, another glorious dry season day, just about the sun to set on it. Bombers have started well here. They seem to have taken Thunder out of the contest as the ruck scalator coming from deep there was Verncombe. Oh geez, some great pressure, great tackle in the end was Matty Thompson. Umpire comes in to ball it up about 60-65 metres around from the Bombers' goal. Yeah, it must be said as well, Thunder, I don't think, have been anywhere near inside their full 50 as yet. So the rucks again. Oh, geez, getting them high there was Verncombe. Sharked away there was Oxley. Argus is in there. Matty Argus for the Thunder. Sondergel nicely played in front of Lockie Argus. Also in there was Alan Bielski. Geez, coming over the top there with a bit high on Matty Argus, and he'll get the free kick. So Thunder, they can work it away here. Numbers lining up all over
the switch of play.
That's what they need, and he goes over towards Sean Tapp. Now, once he got up the line, there's a large hold of space, but Benny Rioli's there. That's what he does. He chips it up the line. Now he can work into some space here. Benny Rioli, cap and all, goes towards the outer side of the ground in front of the scoreboard looking for Lockwood. I judged there was Ethan Kelly. Coming in, crashing over the top was Julian Lockwood. Once again, Kelly wins it back from whence it came. Salter handballs over the top towards Howard, who handballs it sideways, and they're out of trouble again here. Lovely kick up the line finding James Webster. And now they've got numbers again. Look at the space they're getting. Coming away with it. Anderson tries to affect the spoil. Can't do so. Page now for the Bombers. Handball's back from whence it came. Oh,
great
look out.
Tackle.
Great tackle in the end there from Matty Argus. Great chasing in there away here. Smith now tries to pump Thunder inside 50. Looking for the big fella in Darren Ewing. He's nicely judged in the end there. It looked like it might have been Sondergeld, and they can come away with it now. And he finds Travis Reynolds right in front of the scoreboard. Moves it on quickly, and this is what the Bombers have been doing so far, but it's a poor kick in the end, and he ends up finding Willie Cossack. So, again, the numbers lining up here across the ground, goes over the top and finds Kieran Smith. They just don't seem to be running around in circles at the moment, Thunder. Wherever they seem to be going, they've got a Bomber with them. Ash Duncan now coming away with it, chipping it up the line. That's a good kick in the end for Ewing. Oh, couldn't quite get it on the second attempt. No, he couldn't. In the bottom of the pack there was Phil Cast. He sharked away there nicely. Was Clouston in the end. In fact, it was Reynolds. And they're coming away. Geez, a bit of a scrap there between, looks like, Willie Cossack and Alan Bielski. And the free kick is...
Cossack will get a free kick for... Zufa was going over his shoulder, so Cossack on the outer side, 80 metres out from the Thunder's attacking goal, and a fine mark taken on the 50 there by Darren Ewing. Now, he knows this ground quite well, and he'll know his distance on this one, so he'll have to take one of his best kicks. It's a little bit of a faint sort of crosswing going at the moment. So Darren Ewing, from underneath the scoreboard, fancies himself from here. No goals as yet. Lovely looking kick. Big booming
it's
looking kick. I reckon he's got that. It's a sausage roll and the first one for the NT Thunder. Great effort there and against the run of play as well, as Redland have had ample chances on getting it down. And it's interesting the way that both sides are going about it. The switcher play is really where it's going to open up this game. I know we talk about often how, you know, that quick little side kicker across half back is really going to open up the flanks here. Mm. But there's really three corridors here today because it is that wide straight through the middle of the ground.
Yeah, it certainly is. And geez, again, that kick there, you see the Thunder boys practicing torpies just for a little bit of a muck about a training, but Darren Ewing could not have hit that any sweeter there, and he's got Thunder away for the night. 8 minutes gone here at Northline. Going up for the ruck here for Thunder is Jaden Pryor. Wins the tap down in front of Vassell. Coming in us on the side there was Rees. He's been good early. Oh, coming in at the top there was Duncan, slightly high, and a free kick going to the Bombers through the likes of Ethan Kelly. Has to go and give up some ground sideways. He looks like he's got Salter up the line, and he's also got the big fella in Cloyston. That's a lovely kick in the end in front of Sean Tapp. He's got his work cut out for him. He goes up towards the goal square. Great nice kick in the end. Oh, Alan Bielski dropping what he should have taken. In there close was Duncan. Coming in also the top was Jack McDonald. Beautifully well done there. Great pressure by Thunder. Rioli works it away now. The weapon in Nathan Brown. Trying to assess his options. Goes up towards the scoreboard side. Really didn't have anything on in the end. And he finds Zane Pringle just in front of Julian Lockwood. And again, it is like the under-8s here at Northline. There are just players running around everywhere. Oh, slips catch there from Nathan Brown. Beautifully done. Has Paddy Heenan running past, and he's also got it's Jack McEwing running past. They're starting to work it through the lines
brilliant.
Now. Jason Rowe, the general, pumps it up towards Jackie Lawler. He's also got Darren Ewing there as well, trying to work his opponent there in Boone under
Farrah's
the ball.
On in the square.
Farrah's on in the square if he can get it to him. Nice pressure, though, in the end by Brad Rees. All coming back over the top there. Taking him over the boundary line was the likes of Bielski, and the ball goes out about 45 around from Thunder's goal.
So a good start now, starting to ease themselves into this game now at the NT Thunder. It's quick free-flying football, whether that lasts for the full four quarters, and fatigue will play its factor in this game, you would think, with just the size of the ground, as the 244s see it over the boundary line there in Salter and McEwen. It'll be interesting to see how the lights take effect here. Obviously, yep. You were down here at training earlier in the week, Josh. Any dark pockets or anything like that we might need to worry about?
Slightly dim in the northwest corner of the ground, which is, if you're watching on Thundervision, it's where the Carlton mid-sign currently is, and also behind each goal, it does get a little bit dark.
So Salter gets a quick kick away, only to the avail there of Lachlan Argus. He sort of just mucks around with it. Page on hands and knees, along with McEwen. Hand passes to his opposite number, and away go the likes of the Bombers. And a fine mark taken there by McDonald. So McDonald looking for options as they spread. Haven't seen much of Mr. Spreadable tonight. They go across to the interchange, and a fine mark taken there by the weapon in Nathan Brown, right in front of the Thunder interchange.
Might have hurt himself here. Copped a knock on the way through.
A little bit of a Dustin Fletcher going on, maybe a groin muscle. That's what happened against the Blues today. Big winners there. Lachlan Argus in trouble. Got it away. No, he didn't. Fine tackle that time there by Rowan Page. And, that's what they need. The 1% is here for the Bombers, just to stay in touch. I know it's only 5 points, but the Thunder do have a knack of getting on a roll and pretty damn quickly. So the Bombers have plenty of the ball. They go laterally. Patrick Heenan doing some work, and a fine mark taken there by Howard. So Howard on the outer side, plays on quickly, looks for Pringle. He'll put it out in front of Cloyston and seen over the boundary line. And it will be thrown in, roughly 25 metres out from the Redlands goal. As the sun sets on another glorious day. Darwin Festival in vogue at the moment. Great chance if you are ever thinking about going for a trip. Don't worry about going to Europe. Come up to the top end. You'll be definitely entertained. So as Vassell puts his head over the ball. Also there is Pringle as well. Cossack trying to scout the ball there. Islet pops up this time. Jason Rowe punches down to Argus. Under a bit of trouble here at the moment. Cluson on hands and knees, going head high there that time. And a free kick going the way of Sean Tapp. So Sean Tapp on the last line of defence, looking for options. Matthew Rosier on there. Oh, smothered. In trouble at the moment. They're going to link up here. The Bombers, no, great defensive pressure here by the Thunder. Geez, they work well in the clinches, don't they? Islet just looks for some space and some reprieve. And he finds Ben Rioli. He chips it across to Jake Dignan. Another Palmerston Magpie linked with the NTFL club. There's Mr. Spreadable and Chris Dunn. He chips it across, finds the skipper. Bit of product in the hair nowadays there with Cameron Islet. So it goes long. So the Thunder, just near the scoreboard, trying to make some options, heading in the Ewing direction. Patrick Keenan also there. Put some pressure on. There's a fine tackle there that time on Kelly. And he's been pinged for holding the ball. And 50 metres as well for swearing. So Patrick Keenan's going to get the second goal of the day for the NT Thunder. So a bit of back chat and, well, a quick tackle there by Patrick Keenan and away you go.
It was a great tackle. Obviously, the umpires, and he pops it through, is the umpires going to be hot on holding the ball, and they're not taking any abuse whatsoever tonight. And, again, you know, we've seen it a lot over the course of the season, holding the ball. Always a contentious rule at various levels. But in the end, Paddy Heenan extends the lead to 11 points for Thunder, and they just seem to have broken the shackles here a little bit. Two straight goals, 12, to one behind. And
well, they've had so much of the ball, and these little errors that they're making in front of goal, I thought, well, McDonald had a chance there to just make a quick snap, didn't make the most of the opportunity when he had it. They're very close and conscious at the moment.
They are. So the ball now back in the middle. Coming out to meet it there was Passfield. Handball's over the top towards Webster. And again, they're trying to chip it around as well. Again, a bit of a scrubby old kick towards the boundary line. Kieran Smith taking it over there. Ball will be thrown in centre wing on, I guess you could say it's the schoolyard side of the ground.
I'd say our cameraman wing, you could say.
Could say
boys
well.
For the cameras.
Give us away, boys, if you can see us there as the ball comes back in the boundary. Throwing a very deep throw in the end. Verncombe has to come from a couple deep. Geez, jumping over the top there was the skipper in Cammy Island. Pumps it up towards centre-half forward. Oh, nicely done there. Geez, getting bodied out of it. You don't see that too often in Willie Farrow. The Bombers are away here, or are they? Beautifully spoiled there by Ben Rioli. And now the Sheriff in Jackie Lawler can... Oh, he couldn't quite rape him.
Still there.
In the morning. Beautifully done, though. Gets the handball away. The umpire says play on. Ben Rioli's in there. So too is Phil Cast. The umpire's going to have to ball it up here. Gee, that was beautifully done by Ben Rioli to hold up the situation there. Looked like Farrow was away. As Thunder now, again... Are they going to get stuck in this pocket? Geez, spoiled away there was Verncombe. Oh, the fresh area from Jake Dignan.
Jackie Chan.
Just about took someone's head off as Matty Argus bursts his way through looking for Smith. Bodies go flying in everywhere. There's Rees, there's Cars, there's Cammy Islet, there's Jackie Lawler. On the bottom of the pack there, yeah, that's definitely a free kick. James Webster for the Bombers there. Just coming in a little bit too... He gets a little bit gung-ho sometimes, does Brad Vassell. Can give away the odd free kick in that situation.
You'd rather have him doing that than doing nothing at all. As the ball goes up in the Duncan and Bilski direction, Clouston flies from the side, but Bilski again picks up the ball. The centre link up well now. The Bombers is going to head in the direction, and well, trying to get into the direction of Pringle, but it's well chopped off there by Ash Duncan. So Duncan chips it to his captain in Islet, and Islet will slow things down. He'll go laterally. And a great kick out there to Sean Tapp.
Oh.
So Tapp drops what he, well, really should have snaffled, and he's kicked it. A big turnover there, so really muck that up there as Passfield has the ball. Chips it across, and the Bombers trying to make position. Geez, they're all over the place at the moment. Zufa making a lead out onto the wing. He instead likes to go back inboard, so the Bombers looking for targets at the moment. A fine mark taken there by Webster. He plays on. Gaps are starting to open up for the Bombers in the forward line. And a fine mark taken there by Clouston, and the Thunder were all over the place that time. They didn't know whether they were playing man or zone or whatever was going on, but the big full forward wearing number 9 in Clouston will line up on a 45-degree angle. Not even that, really. Probably 55 in some thoughts. And he'll go for goal. So a nice-looking lead up to it. Ash Duncan on the mark. Oh, my goodness gracious me. It's coming your way, Josh. Doesn't even make the goal there. Under pressure there that time. There is Page. Diving on the ball is Cossack. Ooh. Going in hard is Islet. They're jumping all over the place. Pringle underneath everyone. And the ball will thrown up. And, well, that's the bad case of the wobblers there with that kick. and the ball will be thrown up only metres out from the goal mouth of the Redland Bombers. And young Pringle and Isla going toe-for-toe at the moment. As the ball is bounced, Clouston punches it away. Pringle looking to snaffle this one. No one really having a crack at the goals here. They go far and wide, a high up and under kick. Going towards the goal mouth. Will it be punched through? It is so. And it was a great-looking kick that time there by Oxley. I should say young Thompson. And away go the Thunder.
So Cameron Isla now has the ball for Thunder at half-back. Trying to see if he can open it up a little bit. The zone is working beautifully. Girl searching, kick up the line for Dignan. The acrobatics couldn't quite do it in the end. Free kick's been pulled out here. Missed a spreadable. Chris Dunn goes up towards half four. Jeez, he's got a tap there in acres of space and he finds him. Now what's he got on over the top? He's got the big fella in Ewing. The kick was a little bit short of a gallop in the end.
Backman's kick.
There was a backman's kick. And in the end, the ball's come away. Looks like it's Phil Cast there who takes it now. And the Bombers can work it away. Up the line going looking for Salter. He finds him. And again, they're getting plenty of numbers around the ball. The Thunder not having the room to move that they're so accustomed to. Getting the hurry on now for the umpire. Goes and finds Brad Rees. And again, it's sort of stopped to a bit of a walk, really. Lots of players in the zone. Or coming out to meet it. Not quite there for the captain in Cammy Islet. They've got some numbers out on the grandstand side of the ground. This time it's Brad Howard for the Bombers. A nice little chip over the top. Oh, the slips catch in the end from Adam Boone. The great David Boone would have been very pleased with that one. Good kick up the line. Good searching. Dropping what he should have taken there was Salter. Has to give up a little space and handball back towards Hunter. Good kick up the line.
Out of bounds on the
floor. That's got to be out of bounds, surely. The umpires say no. In fact, no. We're gonna have a conference call here, and I think the umpire, the NT umpire, and Simon Walker is going to say, I think Thunder might deserve a free kick. No, the decision's going to stand. Well, there you go. We move on as the Bombers, I should say, are trying to move on as well. Got some options here on the grandstand side of the ground. They're sort of chipping it away and around the zone. Jeez, I got some numbers out here. All by himself for a country mile was Phil Cass. He's got a little bit of space over the top there to go to Tommy Salter. Clouston now coming up the line to meet it. That's the direction he goes. Julian Lockwood's going to have to be good here. Good spoil in the end. And can Thunder work it away? Yes, they can. No, not quite. Roe couldn't meet it. They go back inside 50. Coming out to meet it is Page, and a good spoil away there from Cossack. Duncan's in there. Nice bit of body work. Cossack trying to go for the second, the third, the fourth bite. The big man in Jaden Pryor comes back in over the top. Nice little handball there was Tom Salter, and unable to keep it in there was the likes of Rowan Page. The ball goes out about 15 metres around from the Bombers' goal.
Well, we've been going just on 19 minutes in this first quarter. Two straight, the Thunder, to two behinds the Redland Bombers. As the ball is thrown in, only metres out from the Redland goal mouth, and the amount of times we've said that in this first quarter, it's been mouth-watering. So Cossack goes long, looking in the tap direction. Tap now on playing as a forward centre at the moment. Fine tackle, and geez, he's been taken high. Interesting free kick being paid against Sean Tapp there. Held without the ball, he was saying. The umpire is Argus. Battles it out there with Zufa. Switching on there was Rosier. Gives it out to Cossack, who's had plenty of it off half-back tonight. Here comes Matthew Argus on the wing, right in front of our cameraman at the moment. Tapped away there. Mr. Spreadable sees it over the boundary line, and it will be thrown in. So a sort of lackluster start, hasn't seen that free-flowing explosive start that we've seen from Thunder games in the past at TIO Stadium, but I tell you what, this is going to turn into a cracker, you would think, as the umpire on centre wing throws it in. Nice high arc, and you'll need that on this big ground tonight. Geez, misjudges everyone at the moment, and here come the Bombers again, and seen over the boundary line. The Bombers look like they have about 28 men on the ground, and that's only because the runners and the water boys are all wearing white as well, so that could get a little bit tricky as the night wears
very
on.
Confusing.
I'm just waiting for a Peter Cameron sort of mark halfway through the contest. As the ball is thrown in again, plenty of players around this stoppage. Only four players in the attacking 50 for the NT Thunder. As a free kick is being given away there to the Bombers. And they'll look to set things up now off centre wing. So, slowly but surely, little chip kick finds Rees. Rees linking up. Looking for more options. Clouston presents, and I think his speed and nimbleness is really going to test the big fellas up back tonight as Rowe collects the man in Salter, and it's seen over the boundary line. And, well, the big man from Jabiru, no holds bar, and, well, the Bomber boys are coming out and tapping him on his head, but I don't think he needs that right now. as the ball is thrown in again, as we've had pretty much four stoppages in a row. So this is a big chance for Redland to get on the scoreboard with a major. As Brown's around this spillage, Rosier, little terrier that he is, gets it out to Dignan. Tinnell tunnels it away, out goes the weapon. He falls over, keeps his feet though in the end. Great work there by Mr. Spreadable. He pops it up in the Tap direction. It's a one-on-one battle. Tap uses his body well. He's got to take on two. He plays on quickly, does the Bombers. Great work there on the outer side. There was Thompson. He moves it quickly. Here come the Bombers, this time through Salter. He's back on his feet, good to see. They play on quickly, the Bombers. They're in a bit of trouble. All some fancy punch work. Probably got that from the Australian volleyballers earlier in the week. And it will be thrown in yet again. So a lot of stoppages, and that's what they were trained for during the week.
Absolutely. 22 and a half minutes going here at Northline Oval in the beautiful city of Palmerston. Hasn't been free-flowing, but geez, it's been entertaining to watch. Another high looping handball, one down there in the end by Paxman. Geez, a spread of players coming in over the top. Matty Rosie is swan diving for free kick. The umpire's not interested. And the umpire will come in and ball it up. Again, geez, looking around, it does. It seems like there's about 28 Bombers out there. It seems like the Thunder have doubled up and have got a couple of extra teams out there as well. There are players everywhere. As Dignan now tries to shark it away for the Thunder. They're just letting it go, trying to get it away. Lawler comes in, so too does the weapon in Nathan Brown. Great tackle, almost getting the away there from the skipper in Cameron Isler. Geez, dumping in all over it again. And the ball will be thrown up once again. So 10 points the margin in favour of Thunder. And as we said in the pre-game, it's all on the line for them tonight and it's all in their hands. They win the minor premiership and the week off. Nice tap away there from Vernken, but Page can work it away now for the Bombers. A good chip back in towards the centre of the ground and he finds Oxley. What can he do? He goes back over the top looking for Page. 1-2, over to you.
Watch now, for Pringle.
Here comes the big fella in Pringle. The umpire's found a free kick here. I think it might be going to the Bombers. It is. And it'll go to the likes of Alan Bielski. A bit of holding off the ball there from Ash Duncan. Again, a very, very open goal square. He's got some players calling in for it over the top. Oh, he's trying to do a bit of razzle-dazzle around Duncan. He's
trouble?
Going backwards. Where's he going? Someone get him a roadmap. Handsome ball was over towards Zane Pringle. A chip up the line. Couldn't find Sondergeld in the end. They did. They muffed it up in the end. And now Thunder. Oh, they've muffed it up as well. The turnover from Benny Rioli. Looking for Julian Lockwood in the end, finding the big fella in Scott Clouston. What a comedy of errors that was.
Well, look, I'm just waiting for the kick to head in our direction now because I tell you what, the Melbourne Comedy Festival would have been happy with that performance.
So Clouston from about 40 metres
out.
It's another ordinary-looking kick, and Kylie-Anne Rossiter says just the one behind. So they move along to three behinds, Redland. For all the ball they've had inside 50, they could easily be about four or five goals up. But nonetheless, they trail Thunder by 9 points to a two-straight goals 12.
So Ben Rioli, the man with the helmet, thinks safety first. Great for all those juniors out there that want to take the next step. He's also been invited down to the AOS draft camp over the next couple of weeks. So we wish him all the best. As they go backwards, they go forwards through Rosier, starting to link up now. Ash Duncan looking for options. Jason Rowe and also Julian Lockwood making leads. They go a little bit longer, looking for the Sheriff in Lawler. Tap down to McEwen, the Waratah boy. He goes long in the Ewing direction. Two out that time. Has to beat two and just didn't have a crummer at his feet. Fine mark taken there by Reynolds on the outer side. And he'll just slow things up and wait for the cavalry. So Darren Ewing, just a little bit frustrated when his chance does come. He's battling it out with two defenders. How unusual. So the big man in Reynolds bombs it long in the Clouston direction. Punched away there by Rowe, and it will be thrown in. 80 metres out from the Redlands goal, right in front of a healthy crowd here at Northline Oval, as Territorians generally turn up just a fraction later than most. But they've really started to flock here. The embankment's starting to fill up, which is good to see. And a big thank you to the NT government for getting the facility up and running. There's a tap out there that time there by Clouston. And, well, the siren sounds. Only 26 minutes. We have had some quarters that have gone the length of 38 at some stages this year, but it's been a pretty quiet start to this game. On the goal-scoring front, Redland have had their chances in front of goal, but have fluffed every opportunity so far. It's three behind the Bombers, trailing the NT Thunder 2-12. We'll be back in a few moments' time with the second quarter right here on TAS Thunder Vision.
Thank you for this great opportunity to build the ICTHIS LNG project in the Territory. That's why we're giving back to the community.
Students across Northern Australia now have access to more trade skills here in Darwin.
Oil and gas training and research are now available at our university because of this world-class project.
And more than 14 million has been injected into local roads.
We're committed to growing the Territory, so let's take this journey together.
ICTHIS, securing the future.
Authorised by ICTHIS LNG Proprietary Limited Perth.
Palmerston Public Golf Course is a picturesque and challenging championship course, located just 16 minutes from Darwin CBD, at the very heart of Palmerston. The course features PGA qualified coaching and a fully equipped golf shop for all your golfing needs and custom club fittings. It's the perfect setting for a corporate day or a casual round, any day of the week. Palmerston Public Golf Course, at the very heart of Palmerston.
Hello and welcome back to Northline Oval for the second quarter of the round 21 clash between the NT Thunder and the Redland Bombers. 1 week away from finals, both these teams will be featuring heavily in the month of August slash September. We can't just say September because it does get underway next week. The Redland Bombers, will they win, lose or draw tonight? They will finish in this fourth position. Whilst the Thunder, if they get the job done tonight, they will finish in top spot. My name's Ed Cowlishaw. I'm joining commentary as I am always by Josh Sampson. And Josh, we're about to get underway for this second quarter as the players get in their positions. Jed Anderson, Darren Ewing, Lawler, Tapp at centre half forward, Dunn and Islet. That is the lineup there for the NT Thunder in their forward half. As the ball is bounced, a good bounce that time. Well, from our position, it went straight up. But from the wing, obviously, it went far to the right. And Julian Lockwood will have another chance here. Interesting, they've thrown this around and mixing it up. Obviously, Tappy wasn't handling Clouston as well as what he could have in that first quarter. As Rosier looks to shark it, Vassell just goes head first. Doesn't know any other way. He's one of the toughest going around, Brad Vassell. And being marked there by Phil Cast, the captain of the Bombers. Chip it around. Find McEwen now on the outer wing. Jed Anderson making the lead. Oh, he's got his name all over this one. Zufa's going to have to work hard. It's punched down that time. The Sheriff runs straight through the middle of it. It's punched away yet again. Here comes the skipper in Islet. He goes in hard. Rosier's been tackled to the ground. And it's right on the forward 50. Centre half forward, in fact, for the NT Thunder. And it will be thrown up yet again. We've just got underway here in this second quarter. No score changes yet. As Julian Lockwood taps down there to Brad Vassell, tries to get it out. He does this time. Here comes Matty Rosier. He skips and scoops, and he's run too far. He's run too far. That's what the umpire has said. Obviously, that little skip and scoot didn't get him in the way. He did make the most of the opportunity. And unfortunately, it's no score for the Thunder.
So Cass can work it away now for the Bombers. Geez, Brad Vassell, he's been in the thick of it earlier. Good battle there tonight with Brad Reed. He wins the ball game. And the ball goes over the line, looking for delivery. No, the B umpire says we'll throw it in. About 70 metres around from Thunder goal. Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate for Matty Rosier. Those Pistons have got to work doubly hard. So two steps can indeed be up against one. Paxman going up against Lockwood there. Vassell, geez, he's been in the thick of it early. The Pistons in. That's got to be a free kick, surely, to Lawler. And ahead to Rosier. Lawler, the Sheriff, tries to take it. It'll go back to Matty Rosier, the Alice Springs product. He's got his skipper up the line. Jesus, it's an ordinary kick in the end. He asked a lot of Ireland. He kicks it in. No, he doesn't. The boundary umpire says they'll have it. And again, they're inching their way that little bit closer here, Thunder. It feels like there's a bit of a change in intensity as well. Seems like both sides have lifted a cog and they're ready to go pound for pound. Nicely went down there by Paxman to the advantage of Cass, who handballs wide over towards Salter. A very nice kick up the line looking for Clouston, who's been very good so far.
Great tackle. That's good on the ball as well.
Almost got to be holding the ball for Kevi Vernkamp. No, it's not. And now it's the Bombers' turn to inch their way back up the ground towards their attacking zone. Looks like Clouston's going to go up and do the ruck work here. In fact, no, it's Paxman. Everybody jumps for the ball. In the end, it's Brad Vassell who works it away looking for Tapp at centre half forward. But well trapped and well played in the end by Ethan Kelly, who pumps it up the line looking for his teammate there on Bielski. They are on here. Oh, geez, copping one there was Duncan. Nothing doing in the end. Rioli comes in over the top. Look, appealing for the free kick. The umpire's not interested and they'll ball it up. And the breakaway footy there, 20 metres out in front of the Bombers' goal.
Geez, they're peppering at the moment, yep. The Redland Bombers. They've got their chances again, yet again, in front of goal. Only metres out. Tap down there by Paxman. Trying to burst his way through. There is Passfield. And it will be thrown up yet again. No, it's a free kick for being slung. So this time, Passfield might be able to sink the first one here for the Redland Bombers. And can they make the most of their opportunity? This has been the key for them. They've had ample opportunity and just seems as though they want to do too much with it just in front of goal.
Yep. Yeah, Thunder as well. Again, this is some of the undisciplined stuff that we do see creep in from time to time. They really do need to eliminate it from their game so that they're not giving the opposition freebies like this.
So Passfield comes in, does not miss. Did not hesitate, and this is their first major on the night. And he kicks the first one for the Bombers tonight. They've done that well. There's no doubt about it. Great work inside there by Ethan Kelly. Just opened the ground right up with a penetrating kick. They nearly fluffed it at centre-half forward again, but they worked and worked and worked at it, and they've got their just rewards here, the Redland Bombers. So, look, 1-3-9 to 2-12, and this is going to be one of those games where whoever makes the most of the opportunity in front of goal or can lock it in their forward half, they're going to win this game. There's no doubt about that, as the ball is back in the middle, waiting for the umpire to bounce it again. Nice looking bounce. Lockwood doing the ruck work this time, minus a Kenrick Tyrrell tonight. Very close to playing for the NT Thunder as Dignan trying to tackle. Good pressure again there by the Thunder, and away they go. The Sheriff in Lawler, he scoots onto the ball. He kicks it out wide to Darren Ewing. Has to use it. Well, great defensive work there by Boone as he sees it over the boundary line. He's got his job cut out tonight. Obviously, Boone would rather be playing in the midfield or around that half-back line, but he's a strong unit, and I think it's a really good matchup, Boone and Ewing, just with the sizes. So ball will be thrown in right on the 50-metre arc. The NT Thunder's attacking forward half. Tap down again, and here comes another stoppage clearance, this time through Oxley along the wing, looking for Bilski. Bilski on the outer side. Chips it across. And finds the target in Salter, and away they go. Geez, they've done this well here, the Bombers. Looking up in the Pringle direction and a fine mark. And, well, the Redland Bombers really starting to assert themselves. They've been all over the Thunder so far today. It's just that the Thunder have made the most of their opportunities in front of goal. Inside 50 count would be very interesting to see in our statistician's box. So, young Pringle. See what Zane can do. So, just on 50, he will kick. Going to have to kick right through it. And he does just that, but he's put too much curve on it. And it's through four behind. So it's 1-4-10 to 2-12. It's the NT Thunder leading the Bombers. That's the Redland Bombers by 2 points.
Conversion, as we say, so often very important. Geez, a scrubby-looking kick there, trying to find the weapon. It's Cameron Islett, though, who gets it away. Now, geez, wrapped up beautifully in the tackle there was Duncan. No holding the ball. In fact, there is the throw against Tom Salter there. Nice work there by Ash Duncan. Taking a while to get into it, but it's starting to have an impact. The weapon is there, but so too is Sean Tapp, the seven-time Queensland representative. Now doing the NT very proud indeed. A searching kick, asking a lot of Nathan Brown. The weapon, geez, coming in over the top there. He has. He's given away a free kick. It's a bit iffy, one would think. It was stopping and propping there in the end was Simon Taylor, it looked like. So
just get the feeling as though the umpires are preparing for finals as well. The little ticky touchwoods, they're going to be paying them tonight.
Absolutely, as Oxley now goes up the line for the Bombers. Good kick in the end, finding the likes of Sondergeld. In fact, no, it was Godfrey. But, geez, a good searching kick looking for Clouston. And, in fact, Clouston's pushed a little bit further up towards centre-half forward. And, again, this zone that's being set up by Thunder. The umpire hurries it on. And the high looping kick in the end up towards centre-half forward. Jason Rowe has to come from a few deep. Working away, though, nicely was the skipper in Cameron Islett. Good kick to find Dignan. And now the Thunder can work it away. What's he got on? He's got Jaden Pryor in the middle. That's where he goes. Pryor now. He's got Brad Vassell up the line in an acre of space. He's got Mr. Spreadable in the area as well. A great searching lead from Brad Vassell. Not rewarded in the end. The umpire's picked out a free kick. I think it might be going to Bradley Vassell in the end. In fact, no, it's a free kick to Brad Howard for the Bombers again. Just this little sort of ticky touchwood sort of holding on. I think you're right, Edo. They might be preparing for the finals. Howard now, the ball getting back from whence it came. Geez, the Thunder all over him as well. Mr. Spreadable's in there. Handball's back towards Pryor. Loads it up onto that nice kick on the left for Anderson. Good hands by the young fella. And he'll have a shot for the goal from about 50 metres bang on. No, instead, he'll play
football.
On. Going up to look towards the big fella in Ewing. Very nicely done in the end, though, by Brad Howard to knock it through for a behind. A little bit of how's your father been going on there with Daniel Zufa. The Thunder now 2-2-14. Redland 1-4-10. 8.5 going here at Northline.
So Zufa out of fullback. It was the right option there by Anderson.
Yeah,
he did everything right, and there's no doubt about that. Obviously, could have been done a bit quicker, but he didn't see him. So you can't really blame that sort of count back there. So as the Bombers look to, through their captain, just trying to marshal the troops and get them forward yet again. So Phil Cass moves it along, and Pryor to drop that one. I think it was Island, in fact, as he hand passes over there to the weapon in Brown, linking up again. Great work, smothered off the boot. It's going to end up in Dignan's hands, though. He puts his head over the ball, and we'll get a free kick for it. Umpire says play on. No advantage, and right call as well, as Vassal would have been gang tackled by about three of the Bombers. So Jake Dignan looking for options. Ewing looks to clear the square. Jed Anderson also becoming a target. The big ruckman in Pryor. Will they switch play yet again? No, he chips it across there to Smith. So Smith, a true centre-half forward here for the NT Thunder. Players milling all over the place. There's no one in the forward half here for the Redland Bombers. Under a bit of pressure, plays on quickly. The big booming Jason Rowe, one of the goals of the year! What a wonderful kick there by Jason Rowe. A super goal, in fact, if we were playing NAB footy. And, well, he is a Brisbane Lion. He's done it once or twice there for the Brisbane Lions senior side back in the day. But what a wonderful setup there by Smith. He was called through. He could see the pick and roll being set there in the centre square. And, it just worked brilliantly.
Oh, it was fantastic. We could see it. We were right in front of it. That was a set play that they've obviously been working on either this week or the last couple of weeks. And Jason Rowe, the finish in the end. Who said anyone down there can kick like a backman? That sailed majestically through the middle for a sausage roll. So 10 and a quarter gone here as the ball back in the middle. One down by Jaden Pryor. Geez, Matty Rosier copping one high. No, the umpire says I'll ball it up. And 9 points now for Thunder in what's been a pretty scrappy contest, very contested. That is a handy advantage. Now switching into the ruck there was Reynolds, but they can work it away. Oh, geez, Lawler a bit slow. Good tackle in the end by Rowan Page.
There they go.
And they are out here again. It's the slingshot in reverse, you can almost say. Page now, geez, wobbly old kick. He's going to ask a lot of his teammate here in Phil Cass. Going in there nicely as well was Simon Taylor. He works it back from whence it came to Page. Oh, nicely done over the top was Paddy Heenan. Knocks it down to his skipper in Cameron Islet. And he's wrapped up and the ball will be bounced about 60 metres around from the Bombers' goal. So, again, huge pack of players milling around this contest. Nice bounce by the umpire at the end. One down by the ruckman there in Reynolds. Thump forward. Here's an opportunity for the Bombers. Geez, coming from about 4D, there was the big fella in Clouston. Snapping it around the corner. Couldn't quite get it on the boot was Bielski. The pressure is intense. It is unbelievable. You've got to be on your feet this evening as the ball and the true centre-half possession goes for another ball down there. Simon Walker, the NT umpire, the NTFL Grand Final this year. So one down there. Vernkin wins it down into the advantage. He coming away, bursting away from the pack there beautifully was Anderson to the little Terry and Rosier, to the Sheriff in Lawler, to the weapon in Nathan Brown. Beautiful link-up play. Oh, couldn't quite get it to come off in the end. And Jackie Lawler fumbling what he should have taken. The ball goes out just in front of the scoreboard. Almost 12 gone here at Northline Oval.
Key stoppage here for the NT Thunder just to create a little bit more of a buffer. The Bombers have penetrated their forward 59 times so far tonight compared to the NT Thunder 6. So they've really, really gone at them hard early on. Just haven't made the most of their opportunities in front of goal. And some wobbly kicks coming out of the Bombers' outfit tonight. Just obviously the intense pressure that's out there and perceived pressure as always is Tap doing the ruck work this time here for the NT Thunder as they're trying to win a tap out. Free kick. Just waiting for which way it's going to be heading. And it is against the Thunder. And Taylor will take the kick. So he chips it across just in front of the scoreboard. With the Thunder having a 9-point lead.
Oh,
so
well
Jones had his kick smothered. Mr. Spreadable's underneath this one. Stacks on the mill, waiting for the umpire's call. Will they let it play on? He does so at this stage. It's tunnel ball action at the moment. They're all lining up for a game at Twister. But here comes the likes of the Redland Bombers trying to work themselves forward. And Passmore sees it. Passfield, I should say, sees it over the boundary line. So right on the forward 50 marker for the Redland Bombers. As Passfield could take this unattested. He taps it out in the end. Here comes Pringle. Another quick handball around. Geez, they've got to have a shot sooner or later. Bielski chips it across. Tries to find a man. Unmarked. Drops what he should have taken. Plays on quickly. It was Zufa that dropped the mark. And a free kick going the way there of Matty Rosie. These are the sort of little mistakes that they're making inside their forward 50. They're working so hard. They're doing the hard stuff in defence. But they're just not making the most of their opportunity. So Willie Farrer, who's now on the ball, gives it off to the Sheriff in Lawler. Lawler being marked by Sondergeld off to Anderson. captain of the under 18 Division 2 champs this year. Dignan clashes there with Passfield, gets it out. They're just mucking around with the ball at the moment, the Thunder, looking for options. Dignan shakes and bakes, moves it backwards. It looks for Anderson again. Zufa underneath it. Couple of tired players. And by that attack on the ball, a free kick going the way of Zufa. So Zufa kicks it long. Oh, they're on like a monkey's uncle at the moment. Here comes Oxley. Oxley's got a paddock to play with. You can tune in on Mix 104.9 a little bit later on tomorrow morning for that one as he plays on quickly and a fine mark. Taken, dropped, play on, waiting for the umpire's call. No, it has been a mark. And it's going to the big fella in Clouston. So let's see what he does out of this one. 45 metres out from goal on that angle as well. So Clouston needs to kick right through it. Seen a couple of wobblers from it. That's a little bit better kick. That's a much better kick, but way off target. And it's through for another behind. 1-5 plays 3-1. It's the NT Thunder leading 19-11.
So almost 15 minutes gone here at Northline Oval. Fantastic facility. Great to have your company here on Tats Sun Division. That is a searching kick in the end to find Willie Cossack just in front of the scoreboard. He's got McEwen up the line. This has been the problem for Thunder so far. When they get to about this point, it's a case of where to from here. Well, where to from here at the moment is Bradley Vassell, the Wanderers flyer. He's got tap in the corner at centre-half forward. Oh, it's asking a lot of him, isn't it? And it is. It bounces in front of him. He falcons himself in the end. And the ball goes out for a boundary throw-in. Pretty much the true centre wing on the outer side of the ground. Of course, our production team from Kick Digital are out there. Give us a wave if you can see us, boys, as the Rucks go at it. Lockwood wins it down in front of Paxman. But they can work it away here. Done nicely there was Thompson. Throwing it on the boot up towards centre-half forward with Stout Milkins.
Could have a shot.
But also, there is Lockie Argus. They're away here. He's got Paddy Heenan in space. He's got Mr. Spreadable over the top. He's asked a little bit of Paddy Heenan. The kicks aren't finding the targets. Nicely done there by James Webster, who sees the ball. Oh, it's on here.
There we go.
Something has been said or done, and they're not happy. The umpire says everybody settle down. In fact, no, he's picked out a free kick. And Webster says, "Righty-o, I'll take it away." Oh, the slips catch there almost taken by Duncan. Throwing it on the boot was the big fella in Clouston. It's going across the face. Can he get there? In the end was, looks like the likes in the end of Zane Pringley couldn't. Well, that was very interesting. Everybody stopped, so did the umpire, and nobody was really sure what was happening there. But it's Thunder 3-1, leading Redland 1-5. And again, the inside 50s that they've had, they really should be along further in front. Can they get a goal out of this one? The Rucks going at it again. Clouston wins it down for the Bombers. Jeez, getting Falcon almost in the air. It was Dignan, I think, in the end. And Jackie McEwen sees it over the boundary line. Almost 16 and a half gone here at Northline Oval.
So back from whence it came as it just tumbles over again. 10 metres out from Redland's attacking goal mouth. High arc on this one. Clouston also doing the ruck work there with Vern Combe, trying to shark it out. No one in. Oh, a little bit of a Jackie Jan again. That time there by Salter. And having a look if there's free kick. Just waiting for some sort of a decision to be made. It is going to be thrown up right into goal square, so look for this one to be punched through. Although Redland have been pretty good at the stoppages so far tonight. See how they go here. No Nick Davis around tonight, which is good news there for the NT Thunder. A quick kick away. Salter, ping for holding the ball. Did he have a chance to get rid of it? They're right on it tonight, the Leprechauns, as they chip it across. The NT Thunder and a fine mark being taken there by Jed Anderson. So Anderson on the outer side looks for Mr. Spreadable. Marks in front of Howard. He plays on quickly. Great hard running there by Anderson. Oh. But good chip off there that time by Thompson. So Thompson goes back from whence it came. Definitely not a ground for high scores, you would think.
No.
As, well, they're just making the most of the opportunity around the wings here at the moment. So here come the Bombers trying to draw a man this time. It's nothing but black shirts there. And Jason Rowe looks to just go straight up the guts. And he does just that. Fine mark. Well, probably dropped what he should have taken there that time. There was the likes of Lockwood. He chips it across there to Ewing. Now he's got to take on five or six of the white shirts in the Bombers. Great work there from both sides to lock it in. It did end up getting out. And we're just waiting for a free kick coming the way of the NT Thunder. So Darren Ewing, far from home, finds Jed Anderson. He's got a pad to play with. Oh, beautiful work. Oh, he's been pinged for holding. No, he hasn't. He got rid of it in the end. It was a great tackle there by Howard. He goes along the outer side, and away go the Redland Bombers. They're going to start to link up. Here comes Salter. He's had plenty of it tonight. Interfered with just as he kicked it, but play on, says the umpire. Players slipping and sliding all over the place. It's not because of the surface. It's because they haven't got the grass cats on. And a fine-looking snap for a behind. And, well, the Bombers are doing it 1 point at a time tonight. And, well, I tell you what, it is 1-6-12 to 3-1-19. And the Bombers just really haven't made the most of their opportunity in their forward line. It's Patrick Heenan. No, it's Ben Rioli that has the ball. Excuse me, as we're 150 metres away from the ball. Good work there by Matthew Argus. Interfered with that time there by Bilski. Jake Dignan says howdy do to him. So Argus chips it across. It's a dangerous kick, but a fine mark, and that's 50, surely, to Nathan Brown. No, the umpire says, no, you didn't deserve that one. Mr. Spreadable on the back line. That's done. Gives it off to his captain.
Well done.
Great work there as Rees came in from the side. Islet kicks it long to Tap. Oh, he drops another one here. So a little bit of a loss of confidence from what we saw a couple of weeks ago. And waiting for a free kick going the way of the Redland Bombers. So Sean Tapp, just a little bit loss of confidence. Taylor has the ball. He goes long. Some smoky cloud
hands.
Comes over the top there. The Bombers under pressure at the moment. Stacks on the mill yet again, and the umpire will come in and ball this one up.
So just heading to red time here at Northline Oval in Palmerston. It's the Thunder leading it by 7 points. It's fair to say that Redland have had just the odd inside 50 or two in this quarter, haven't made the most of it. Sharking it away there nicely was Vassal, trying to get the spill on the outside. There was the weapon thrown on the boot by Mr. Spreadable. Tap's going to have to be good here. Can't work his way from the front position from Pringle. Handballs over the top looking for Cars. In fact, no, it was Alan Bielski. A high looping, coming from deep there was Kieran Smith. Couldn't try and take the mark. In there also, a free kick's been paid and Thunder can work it away here. Vassal, handballs over the towards Matty Argus. He's got Darren Ewing in the goal square. Can he take it? The big fella, he can.
Yay.
Beautifully done by Thunder. Didn't just play to the whistle there and went straight down the guts. That's the NT Thunder we've come to know, and that's why they're playing for the minor premiership tonight.
I think the crowd's just excited that we're going to see a goal. I mean, Redland have had their chances. They've kicked six behinds. The Thunder haven't really had it that much in their forward 50. When they have got it there, they've done a lot with it, but I think the crowd's just excited that we're going to see a big six-pointer, and that's what we want.
Yep.
Come on, Buff.
And a very big, healthy crowd, it must be said. It's developed nicely. Only 20 metres out. No angle to speak of. Drills it through. Nicely done by Darren Ewing. Carlian Rossiter says, thank you very much for 6 points. It's 4-1-25 for Thunder. They're out to 13 points, and that is a handy advantage in this type of game. They lead the Redland Bombers 1-6-12.
It's amazing. Usually you see this score line, and it's associated with wet weather footing.
Mm.
You know, you can't get the ball out. Jeez, imagine if it was raining on this ground.
Geez.
My gosh, we wouldn't see the ball for 4 days. You know, unless they move the goalpost to Auskick level, and, you know, you go across the ground. But it has just been a highly contested game. Skill level, obviously, drop marks have been a worry for both sides, really. But at the same time, it's making the most of the opportunities. And when it's inside the forward 50, Redland have had that chance. This is up to them now to obviously keep a stoppage on things. As Passfield gets a quick kick away, heading in the Clouston direction yet again. Another centre clearance here for the Redland Bombers. But it's Ben Rioli trying to clear the ball as Smoke Hayes starts to fill the ground at the moment. But the Bombers don't care about the smoke. They want another score on the board and hopefully a six-pointer. They start to move it forward. The umpire says a free kick. You can take this one, Bilski. He goes long. They're moving it quickly. Heading in the Clouston direction. Punched away. Seen over the boundary line and will be thrown in. So as a dark haze, and I must stress a dark haze because we're struggling to see the other goal line down there at the moment. So we've got the binocs on. Just trying to see how the Redland boys are staying to set up out of this one. But they've had it in this area so many times tonight. Can they get a goal out of it? Webster on the goal line. Clouston uses his body. You don't want the big fella to go to ground, but he has done so and he's got a free kick out of it. You don't generally want to see the big boys get on their hands and knees. You want them to keep their feet and be a target in the air. But he's done the 1% work here, and they're going to get a goal out of this. Very, very tight angle, but wide pockets here. So here comes Clouston. Clouston lines up, stabs at the kick. Goal umpire moves a fraction, through for a behind. So Well, the kicking boots have definitely been left in the sheds tonight for the Redland Bombers. They've had their chances in front of goal, and you just get the feeling that the Thunder will make them pay at some stage tonight, and this is where it's going to come down to.
So they're looking to work it away. Oh, good contest there. Coming over the top was the skipper in Cammy Island. Thunder trying to work it out of their defensive zone here. They can now through Cossack. Oh, it's a dangerous kick over towards Jason Rowe. That one golden rule, never kick across goal. It can come off sometimes as Rowe now moves it on. And, oh, looks like he might have stepped over the line. Play on was called, so it's going to be another behind to the Bombers. They'll move along to 1-8-14. Bit of an own goal almost there from Jason Rowe. And now they can work it away again. He's got Paddy Heenan just inside the defensive 50. Wonder if they perhaps would be keen to get another goal here to ice the contest. Oh, geez, Benny Rioli maybe milking, trying to get a 50 there against Bilski. He chips it sideways and goes back to Paddy Heenan. So
along the cape.
Yeah, along the cape again.
Along the cape.
Stuck in an absolute landlock over there. There is no water in sight at all. Again, looks like Thunder are almost taking the tempo off it here. That is a booming kick over towards the other side of the ground. He asks a little bit of Vernken, but he's got time to stop and assess his options. He pushes it back up towards Matty Rosier. It's round around the garden like a teddy bear with Matty Rosier. He chips it just up in front of the scoreboard looking for the Sheriff. Nice mark in the end. Good kick. He's got Ash Duncan screaming for it up the line. He's got Mr. Spreadable screaming for it in the middle. He decides to go longer than that. He's got Jed Anderson in front of the likes of Tyler Jones. Couldn't quite trap it in the end. Well done by Tyler Jones. Really did well to hold Anderson out of the contest, and the ball goes out for a boundary throw and about 60 around from Thunder goal.
Well done to both those players. Yeah. They're all by themselves pretty much, except for the cameraman sitting on our scaffolding. And, you know, they've done really well. But look at the open space around here. It's absolutely quite ridiculous. As Lockwood taps it down, great mother this time. Here comes Rosie, tries to save it, seen over the boundary line. He's frustrated by that as well. Had a chance, he was off. If only they had an extra 100 metres to play with, they were thinking. No, they don't. Otherwise, they would have just kept on keeping on into Pratt Primary School. As the ball is thrown in yet again, Lockwood doing the tap work again. Good work there by the Bombers to try and shark this. Reese has the ball, trying to get it out. Seen over the boundary line right again, right in front of our camera station. So plenty of players around this stoppage. As Darren Ewing prepares himself for another assault on goal. Tapped down again, this time by Lockwood. The ruckman for the Bombers hits the deck that time. Reese around this spillage. Also on hands and knees that time there was Taylor. Trying to get it out there is Carls. Trying to just flicked it back in pretty much. The old Teddy Whitten flick pass over there to Webster. Kicks it long and finds the target in Salter. Geez, they're moving it along quickly here. Big chance here for the Redland Bombers as Zufa tries to get rid of it. And great work there by Jason Rowe. So Rowe streams out of defence looking for some sort of a target. It's one-on-one football there that time there with McDonald and Heenan. McDonald wins out. A little chip kick there by Bilski. A worm-burning grubber sort of a kick. Didn't really help there in Stout Milkins. And it's seen over the boundary line and it will be thrown in, you would think. So we've gone from one forward pocket to the other in a roundabout sort of a way. And still no score on the board, which reads 4-1-25 to 1-8-14. Redland have dominated play. They haven't just put the score on the board. So here come the NT Thunder as the crowd start to get a little bit antsy. Jason Rowe playing off his man and did it well that time as he chips it across. Trying the old switch of play. The only problem is it takes 3 hours to switch it from one side to the other side. So here come the Thunder. This time through Lawler. Oh, McEwen goes up. He keeps it in play. Rosie is going to have to work hard. Uses his head, well, maybe not so wisely as what he would have thought. A Redland player is down. A quick kick away that time. There by the likes of Pringle. And I think everyone's happy to have a kick on the ground at half time as we just try and put the binocs on who is down at the moment for the Redland Bombers with a little bit of a head clash. But the scoreline reads 4-1-25 to 1-8-14. A very low-scoring game, probably the lowest-scoring game for the season we've seen anyway. And we'll be back just after halftime with a little bit more of a preview of the second half. And, of course, the second half coming your way on Tats Thundervision on territoryfc.com.au. Great to have your company this evening.
because it gets hard. I see as you get a little bit longer into it, it's harder for you to see. Have a kick with your kid. Huh? No, a ball's more important. There you go, and fix it. Alright, let's get a ball. Where'd you get the other one from, Liz? Thank you.
Straight over the ball, mate.
Del Felwood.
Aaron, I'm going to
Hello and welcome back for the second half of this round 21 clash between the NT Thunder and the Redland Bombers. It is a very low scoring match, this one, and you would think that the dew will play its part a little bit later on as a misty, sort of smoky, hazy cloud is started to descend on the ground. A bit of burning off action happening here in the Palmerston area. We're 15 kilometres outside of Darwin and we're at Northline Oval tonight as TIO Stadium, where we would usually be tonight, is being resurfaced. I'm joined in commentary. My name's Ed Cowlishaw. Josh Sampson joins us. What do you make of the scoreline and what the story we've seen so far tonight?
Well, the story, I think, Edo, so far is that there's been huge numbers around the ball, a really, really heavily contested game. We mentioned it in pre-game that came out and had a look at Thunder during the week, and they were prepared for this. They were prepared for a bit of a dogfight. 4-1 to 1-8, yeah, obviously for the footy purists, they'd like to see something a bit better, but let's see what can unfold here in this second half.
Well, that's what it's all about, is Paxton and also Willie Farrow to do the ruck work. They'll recall that one and they'll throw it up. They've had a little bit of trouble with it tonight. A bit sandy underfoot, not as sandy as TIO.
The beach.
Well, it is at the moment. There's no grass on it whatsoever. As Farrow just goes a standing start, this is an interesting tactic to put Farrow in the ruck, and a free kick going the way of the Redland Bombers for a heavy hit there from Jack McEwen. He's going to get reported as well, I think, as the umpire pulls out the book out of his back pocket. Looks like charging as well, head-eye contact. And Jack McEwen, number 44, will go into the book. It's not a good thing just before finals. He's not happy about it as well. Be interesting to see what the review get out of this one. So Redland looking for options. Oh, he's off there in Cass. Play on quickly. Great pressure there by the Bombers. Oh, Dignan and McEwen collecting each other in there. The intense up and about now. Here comes a pass field. He kicks it on quickly. Clouston at his feet. Not where he would intended it to have gone. Black shirts around him. Here comes Cass again. The captain for the Bombers. He pops it up in the Pringle direction. He punches it out in front of him. But Patrick Heenan's there. He's cleaned up by Rowe and it trickles over the boundary line. So players bouncing and ping-ponging themselves all over the place. Jason Rowe gets a free kick. He chips it across and finds Bradley Vassell. So Vassell looking for options. Leads being made there by Dignan. Might want to go a little bit longer. The sheriff calling for it, and it might head in his direction. Goes high, up and under. Chris Dunn's there as well. It's tapped to the ascendancy there of Ben Rioli. Players fall on that Phil, there was Oxley. Also out there at the moment is Zufa. He puts his head over the ball, and well, the Thunder boys, they're attacking it with ferocious intensity at the moment, but unfortunately they're giving away costly free kicks. Zufa, oh wow, mongrel looking kick, heads in the rosy direction, spinning out of trouble. There was Salter playing on quickly out of the NT Thunder. They go around the cape yet again, and it's seen out of bounds, and it will be thrown in on centre wing on the embankment side of the ground, where some people are just putting on some, well, air guard at this stage.
Yeah, yes, it certainly would be. Very nice dry night here. Speaking of embankment, it's been absolutely embanked on that centre wing so far as the rucks come down. Tapped down nicely there was Farrah. Geez, coming in over the top there. Thought he was getting one high. Was Vassell, in fact. No, the umpire says you are dead to rights holding the ball.
Wow.
Well, and he's not happy about it either. Dishes out a bit of how's your father been as well. So the Bombers can set themselves up here. Still parked on this grandstand side of the ground. Taking the mark there was Alan Bielski. Been pretty handy tonight for the Bombers. Floating upwards and backwards across the ground. Goes up the line. Oh, couldn't quite take it there was Rees. Heenan tries to work it away. Nicely done. Vercum goes to Rioli. And now they can work it away to the skipper in Cammy Islet. Getting his way through a bit of traffic there. Needs some traffic lights down there, for goodness sake. It's an interesting sort of kick. And Ash Duncan lets the slips catch go through the fingers. In fact, it's out of bounds on the full. And the Bombers can pump themselves back inside 50.
How do you run out of space? I mean, seriously, we've got a whole paddock on the right-hand side of frame. I mean, it's just a little bit ridiculous, Josh.
As Bielski now pumps it up towards half-forward. Small down there was Roach. He's crashing in over the top. They're on if they can get it out here. Cloyster, nicely done. Good tackle there.
Here
over the top was Roach. Working the way now. Duncan tries to redeem himself. Oh, no, he doesn't. He goes straight to the same position. And it's two in a row for Ash Duncan. Not one you'd want to be claiming and putting on the CV, that's for sure. Geez, they move it quickly here. Matty Thompson now up against his opposing number three in Matty Argus. Handballs it sideways, and now they're looking to pump it in again. About a six-on-one situation. Hopeless there for Cluson in the end. Rowe, nicely done to Rioli. Oh, juggling
good
his own
work.
Ball there.
Up
burns
the
away from his opponent. Up the guts is what we want. That's what Thunder fans want. Pumps it up towards Matty Rosier.
Hey,
nicely done. In fact, it was Jed Anderson. Anderson now. Geez, they are on here. A great searching kick for Lockie Argus. He can go inside 50. Chips it up the line. That was vintage footy from the NT Thunder. And Darren Ewing has it about 45 metres out on a slight angle.
It's just smart footy as well. And it's not anything against either side, but no side tonight out there on the field have gone down the corridor.
No.
It's the quickest way down the field, and they've just been mucking around on the wings. The Thunder kicked it out of bounds twice on the full before. And finally, they got a shot on goal. Let's see what Buff can do.
So, again, yet to get on the... He's got one goal to his name tonight. Kick on the way. He's made it two for the night. Great kick there. Great footy from Thunder. And they get themselves a little bit of breathing space in a low-scoring contest. 6-1, 37 NT Thunder. 23 points in front of the Bombers. 1-8-14. Almost five gone here at Northline Oval in Palmerston.
Well, they're up and about, the Thunder, which is good to see. And you sense the intensity was up at the start of this quarter. They're tackling.
Yep.
A couple of free kicks going against them, but that was because of the ferocity of their tackles. A little bit head high as well. Jack McEwen's been reported for head high contact as well. But at the same time, their intent is there now. And
yep,
this is where the Bombers need to respond. They did so well in the first half with their clearances. Let's see what they do out of this one. They're going to go with the bounce, the umpires. This will be interesting to see which way it goes. Good bounce that time. Tap down that time there by the likes of Reynolds, who tries to get it out. Stacks on a mill again. Here come the Thunder again through Argus. This is Matthew. He goes long in the Ewing direction. Willie Farrah jumps early, as he always does. A free kick going his way, perhaps.
Yeah.
It is so. In fact, it's Cameron Islet that went early. And the man that's got a little bit more product in the hair, as he's got some hair on the head nowadays. He shaved it for a good cause. Shaved for a cure a little bit earlier on in the year. Might remember him with the long, Goldilocks sort of hair. Wouldn't call him Goldilocks. He'd probably get you in a headlock and tickle you. So Cameron Islet from directly in front, 40 metres out. Captain's goal needed for the Thunder.
Great
good
kick.
Looking kick. Great looking kick. Does not deviate. And neither does the goal umpire, and another one on the board. And well, the intent is there for the Thunder. They want that top spot on the Northern Conference ladder to really set themselves up for another tilt at, well, maybe back-to-back-to-back flags. So, well, when you win two flags in a year, I mean, what do you? How many back-to-backs do you got?
Well, we discuss that off air. But talking at Goldilocks, that one was just right for Cameron Island. A beautiful hit off the boot, and again, they're starting. This is the points of the game now. That third premiership quarter where Thunder really start to head away and start to really take a stranglehold on contest. So almost 7 minutes gone here in this third term. Beautiful tap down there by Verncombe, coming away with Wes Anderson. Tahina, they're going right through the guts here. They're going in for the kill. Lockwood has to grubber a kick up towards half forward. Paddy Heenan is there on his hands and knees, done beautifully to Mr. Weapon. Spreadable. Oh, Chris Dunn. It's an absolute Barry Crocker in the end. And unlike the Redland Bombers, the Thunder have got another blemish on the scoreboard. 6-2, 38 plays, 1-8, 14, 7 and a quarter gone in this third term.
So Howard looks to kick it in, shakes one, sells some candy and goes down aisle number 14.
Oh, and played Anderson.
Instead, it's Anderson that sees it over the boundary line and will be thrown in. 70 metres out from the Thunder's attacking goal front. We did say in the second quarter that Redland did need to make the most of their opportunities because we knew that the Thunder would come. And all of a sudden, we're starting to hear the rumbles as the clouds start to hover over Northline Oval as the players spill around this pack. The Sheriff's in town there in Lawlow. Good tackle there that time. Howard ends up with it, tries to get rid of it. Dosey Doe football at the moment. Good work there by Salter, but this time it's Cossack. High up and under kick. Looking for Ewing and also Mr. Spreadable, seen over the boundary line, will be thrown in. I think it's a good move to take young Tappy down there. I mean, he did start down back on Cloyston, but obviously the pace was really starting to muck around with him. Only third or fourth game back for the season. So he's now being a presence up forward as the ball thrown up yet again. Tap does the tap work. Hand passes over the top, looking for someone to get it out. Here comes the weapon. He puts his body over the line. Tap tries to snap it across. That'll test the hip out. Here come the likes of the Bombers trying to clear it. Here comes the Sheriff as well. Also Ben Rioli, a back pocket player. But it's Kieran Smith, smothered off the boot. He goes laterally, looks for Cossack. Cossack links up this time. Lachlan Argus, another back pocket player. They're all mucking around in the forward line at the moment. And a scene over the boundary line will be thrown in. There is not one person in the forward half of the Redland Bombers at the moment, as players are just really just trying to stake their place on land out there at the moment.
Yeah, they certainly are. Almost 9 minutes gone here as Tap wins it down. Beautifully done. Sharking it away there was Vassal. Geez, almost copping one high. Pumps it up towards Darren Ewing at full forward. Couldn't find him. Matty Argus goes to pick up the crumbs. Sticks it around the corner and puts it through. And they are starting to get one hand on the NEAFL Northern Conference Minor Premiership now. 8 goals, 2:50 Thunder. And in fact, 7-2, 44 they move along to you, but they've got a 30-point buffer here on the Redland Bombers, who are 1-8, 14. Matty Argus hasn't perhaps done a great deal so far, but again, popping up with a great opportunist crumbing goal.
Well, it's interesting listening to Daniel Archer at the breakfast luncheon, the breakfast that was held this morning, and he was saying every player out there for the Thunder has their own X factor, and he said about Matthew Argus that his X factor is his tackling, his ferociousness on the ball, the one percenters that he does, and if he can pop up and kick a goal or two, it just makes him even more dangerous.
Looks like Julian Lockwood's moved back into the ruck for Thunder as the ball goes down. One down in the end by Julian Lockwood. Trying to shark it out there is the likes of Brad Vassal, but they can work it away here through Rowan Page. Can the Bombers? Coming out to meet it there was Howard. Couldn't take the ball, but now they're throwing it forward. A high, scrubby-looking kick. He's got Zane Pringle. Coming over the top was Jason Rowe. Couldn't take the mark, but he butters up his own footy nicely, and they're coming away with it again here, Thunder, and he ends up finding Kieran Smith on the scoreboard side of the ground. In fact, it's Mr. Incredible, Chris Dunn, who's not had his usual impact tonight, but is starting to come into this match. A wobbly looking kick in the end. Asked a lot of Bradley Vassal, and now the Bombers starting to assess their options. Oh, geez, it was a scrubby looking kick off the boot, but he found Brad Howard in the middle of the ground. They're starting to plug it up nicely here at Thunder. Asked a lot of the kick in the end of Tom Salter. Nice tackling pressure coming in over the top was Lockie Argus. Beautifully done there to win the contest. The Sheriff in Jackie Lawler to Jason Rowe, bustling his way through the middle. Handballs over the top towards the weapon in Nathan Brown, who gets the duke and goes whack up towards Sean Tapp. Oh, couldn't quite take the mark. Did well. Can he butter up his own ball? Here he can. Some good tackling pressure in there by a couple of Redland Bombers defenders, and the ball goes out about 15 around from Thunder. the goal.
Geez, they're really making a statement now, the NT Thunder. Yeah. It seems as though they've woken up from their slumber. They've done all the hard work early on and they knew that the Bombers were coming. Might have been a different story if they had kicked straight, as the ball is deep in the forward pocket for the NT Thunder. Off hands there and slapped out of the pack, heading in the McEwen direction. He's taken the mark and he'll line up from 30 metres out directly in front. Interesting to see what comes out of the tribunal this week with that collision that we saw a little bit earlier this quarter. Obviously, we know that Kenrick Tyrrell's got some points against his name.
Yep.
Probably the only real player that the Thunder have to worry about if anything happens next week or even in finals. But I guess it helps when you're injured and you're trying to get back into it. As Jack McEwen, oh, yes. Oh, lovely looking, bending back, straightening it up. Umpire comes in front of us and sticks the two fingers up. He'll be guilty. Another goal there for the NT Thunder, and they're starting to waltz away with this one. And we've only been going 12 minutes, 8.250 to 1.814. And, well, I tell you what, the Bombers have been well blown away in this third quarter.
Yeah, they have. They certainly have. Because this game has been so close for a long period of time, and now the Thunder have gone bang, 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 and they've unleashed four goals already in this quarter, you almost get the feeling like it's a 10-goal game all of a sudden, that Thunder have absolutely destroyed them from go to woe, and now they're just waltzing away with it. But 12 and a half gone here at Northline Oval as Simon Walker thumps it into the turf. Oh, Willie Farrah, known for his marking ability, known for his ruck as well. A good kick in the end, and he finds Lockie Argus. Argus now goes up the line, screaming forward in space. There is Darren Newing. Couldn't quite take the mark. He can butter up his own ball though and go back inside. Has to grub it in front of him. But now the Bombers are in there as well. Nicely worn away there was Bielski. Been very good. That's a good kick. And he finds Cast. Now they've got an opportunity to move it forward here. The Bombers. Good kick up the line.
No,
finding Clouston. He's going to have to go every inch of about 60 metres here. It's a good looking kick.
Pringle.
Up towards Pringle. Oh, the second attempt takes an absolute ripper. Well played by the Bombers on the counter attack. And he shouldn't make a mistake from here, just at the top of the goal square.
Great work by Pringle. He ran 70 metres for this one. It was a wonderful attempt at mark. Don't know if he got first hands on the ball, but three bites of the cherry. Yeah. Lender ended up in his lap, and he's ended up with a mark there. And this one to put a little bit more confidence on the board here for the Bombers. Should make it.
Jeez. No, Kerry Packer's War starting on Channel 9 tomorrow night. That is the Dennis Lilly run-up. I'll have to rename that the Zane Pringle run-up. In he comes now. Oh, he's just squeezed it home. Nice kick in the end. And that is a badly needed goal for the Bombers. An understatement indeed. They move along to 2.820, but they're still 30 points behind NT Thunder, who are 8.250, almost 14 gone.
Well, it's fast.
Yep, sorry.
Fast break football, and look, we are at Northline Oval. look, it's a wonderful occasion here tonight, obviously. The first game to be played out here in Palmerston. Can you see more games being played out here in the future? Because obviously the crowd has flocked in here, and it's also another fan base for the Thunder to really jump onto, I think.
Yeah, I absolutely can see it. There might be some adjustments that need to be made to some of the lighting, and perhaps some of the facilities can be further developed. But again, this is where it's all happening. This is the future home of Territory Footy, where a lot of stars are going to come from.
So Farrah goes early. Clearance one out this time there by the Redland Bombers. They're on the attack this time. A worm-burning kick heading out in the Clouston direction. Trapped there by Pringle. He's under pressure by Rowe. A player falling at the crucial time. There was a Bomber. Here comes Anderson. He plays on quickly, heading out towards the scoreboard. Just kicking for touch, it seems. We know the Wallabies and All Blacks are doing battle tonight, but that's ridiculous. Here comes Zufa along the scoreboard wing. Cossack gets in front. Great work there of Page. Underneath the scoreboard at the moment, trying to get some space for himself. There is Vassal, Argus, that's Lachlan, also trying to create something out of nothing. And a scene over the boundary line. 8.250 to 2.820, 15 minutes and 16 seconds gone. Now in the 19-second mark, but I'm not going to count that all for the rest of the night. I can tell you that right now as the ball is thrown in. 90 metres out from the Thunder's attacking goal mouth. Tapped down this time, and it looks like the Redland boys are going to try and get another stoppage win out of this one. Sondergeld, I should say, is at the bottom of this pack. The umpire will come in, and a free kick going the way of the Redland Bombers. No back chat. Jed Anderson saying a few things there to Sondergeld. Quick kick away, and Redland don't want to make any haste here with this one. Here comes Carls. Straight up the guts they go. Trying to be good with a kick and a fine mark taken there by Clouston. And they've caught on how to play the game here at Palmerston. Move it quickly up the guts. Clouston, a big, long-ranging kick. And it's touched on the line. by Bilski and Duncan, and it's three for a behind.
So they work it away quickly now to Thunder. Jason Rowe there going up the line to find William Cossack, who goes out wide and he finds Jack McEwen. As we mentioned before, might have a case to answer perhaps at the tribunal during the week.
Oh, going?
It's going close to Mr. Spreadable. It's gone out on the full. And look, I know we spoke pre-game and we've said it a lot during the call about playing it on the flanks. That is just ridiculous, to be honest. That's the third.
Do you reckon they can see the line? Because I know from our area we can't see it. But that's, you know, surely you can see guys lining up for the interchange. They're not on the fielders yet. Don't kick it to the pack of Thunderboys on the line.
Exactly right, as Lawler now taken over there by the Bombers. Looking for a free kick there was Cossack and Verncombe. Geez, they're having a lot to say, in fact. The umpire's come in for a little bit of a conference call. No, throw it in, says the umpire. Good call. Let's just take a little bit of the sting out of it, give the boys a chance. In fact, no, now we've got a three-way conversation happening. Now what's going to go on? It's a free kick going to, yes, it is. It's a free kick to Thunder. Jackie Lawler, the sheriff, will take it. He gives off a bit of ground and goes now towards Paddy Heenan. Looking for the switch, perhaps? No, he's going to switch it into the middle of the ground. A good kick finds Argus. Now what's he got on this? Thunder players going this way and that way. One of them's Verncombe. Verncombe now, he's got Argus up the line if he wants him. Jeez, it was a good spoil in the end. Coming over the top there was the big fella in Paxman. The Bombers are away here. Zane Pringle, he's got him up the line. He still wants it. And he finds him in the end. A nice little kick. And now where are they going to go to from here? Clouston, the big gun, is calling for it in the goal square. Oh, geez, a bit of a two-on-one situation. Made it hard for Bielski. Cossack now tries to pick up the crumbs for Thunder. Nicely done in the end. Good smart kick to Paddy Heenan, and the Thunder are away.
So Patrick Heenan, centre-half back for the NT Thunder. 50 plays, 21. The Thunder leading the Bombers. After the Bombers have pretty much held control in the first half, as Duncan looks lace out and easy as you like. There for Willie Farrer, who was marked unattended. And I tell you what, it's just starting to open up at the mouth of centre-half forward for both sides moment. It's quick movement through the corridor, and the Thunder's shown how it's done early on in the piece. Redland have bounced back with two quick goals, and Willie Farrer hoping to get his name on the board as well. Lovely-looking kick. Good-looking kick, straight as a die, and another one on the board for the NT Thunder. 9-2-56 to 2-9-21. It's just straight up the gut sort of stuff, and this is what you need to see, obviously, from two teams that are really looking to push hard deep into August and September.
11 scoring shots for both sides, and it doesn't really need to be said. I'm going to say it anyways, that 9-2 to 2-9.
Synchronicity.
There's a nice woody word for all of you listeners out there. Another Scrabble word as well, indeed. But again, you know, this is just Thunder all over. They've taken their opportunities, they've broken the shackles, and now it's got to a point where it's almost becoming a bit of a same old Thunder game in Darwin, isn't it? Just the way that they can break away and make the NT a real fortress.
Now, look, you're dead right about that. As the ball's back in the middle and players milling around, usually you see a straight line in the forward lines of something. It's just a random motley crew pack at the moment. Going in hard, there was Verkane pushing his player into a situation which was unfounded. Hopping high in the area of Jed Anderson. Oh, geez, they're under the pump, the defence there for the Redland Bombers. Zufa spinning on a sixpence, has to do well here. The weapon through for a behind. They're just attacking, peppering the goals at the moment. It has been thrilling to watch. 5-2 for this quarter so far for the NT Thunder. Well, it's 1-1 for the Redland Bombers as they look to kick out of defence, going along the outer side, heading towards the mound. And Matty Rosier trying to keep it in play. He does just that, running out of space. Cool. Can you believe it on a ground this size? He goes way, way, way back to Kevin Vernicombe. He's trying to find some space. He chips it across. Jeez, this is dangerous football here for the NT Thunder. Ben Rioli's had to work hard. And instead of going forward, they've gone back 100 metres. And I tell you what, young Howard nearly scored himself an opportune goal out of that one. My goodness gracious me.
Yes, I'm sure Coach Daniel Archer, he'll be showing that to the boys ahead of training this week. At the moment, looks like they could be earning themselves a week off and a showdown with the winner of the Brisbane Lions in Southport, but there's plenty of action still to be had. Vassals in there for the Thunder. Gee, sharking it away there nicely, but in comes Jason Rowe, bullocking his way through. Oh, a bit of a turnover the end. He kick a long high kick from Simon Taylor up towards the forward line. Shark nicely in the end. Well done. No, he's missed it. Jeez. Of all the opportunities they've had, and there hasn't been many in this quarter, they need to start taking the most of them. 2-9-21, plays 9-4-58.
So Ben Rioli looking for options. He'll probably chip it to Heenan, you would think. He goes long. No, he hand passes off to Heenan instead. trying to link up on the outer side. Patrick's got really nothing to kick to. Has to go over the top. Misjudging at that time. Maybe being held onto there was Chris Dunn. It's a foot race. Falls at the crucial time. And away go the Bombers from Baxham, whence it came. Willie Cossack in the area along with Ben Rioli. Like at a deli line, ordering some Strasbourg. They were lining up for that one. Hand passes over the top. Ben Rioli in the middle. He shakes and bakes and unfortunately rolls the wrong way. He's tackled. The ball is just volleyballing its way up the middle of the ground. But there's still making ascendance with it.
Oh,
great
hands.
Mark. Brilliant mark there by Jed Anderson. He goes even long. It's not on target. And it's seen over for a behind. And, geez, they get a little bit too excited about proceedings here, the Thunder, and they put another behind on the board. It was coast to coast. It was sort of worm-burning, finger-breaking, mongrel punt sort of stuff. But nonetheless, a bit of entertainment for the fans.
So just over 22 minutes gone here at Northline Oval in Palmerston. Thunder by 36 points. Dude, that's a long, searching kick. Jaden Pryor's going to meet it first. In fact, I reckon that's missed. Everybody know. I thought it was going to go out in the full.
It was touched.
It was touched, and the ball goes out for a boundary throw-in. Jeez, it must be said, we mentioned it off-air. It is a very dim pocket just in front of the Carlton mid-sign. Nonetheless, we move on as the Rucks go at it. Pryor, the big frame, wins it down towards Rosier. Sharks it away, kicks up towards full forward.
Oh,
coming over the top there for a big one was Tap, I think it was. And it's been socketed through in the end. I think it's Mr. Spreadable, isn't it, Edo? Chrissy
Dunn. It's Darren Ewing that's got it. He's in the right place at the right time, as always. And look, that was fantastic stuff there by Darren Ewing, just sharking the ball there. But Matthew Rosier, he's desperate for that goal that he had taken off him in that second quarter. He was just pipped at the post, just ran a couple of extra twinkle-toe steps than he should have. But look, I tell you what, the Thunder, they're really starting to stamp themselves on this game. 10-4, 64 to 2, 10-22. Oh, geez, missed opportunities definitely for the Redland Bombers. But you know what? From now on in, we're not going to say missed opportunities or anything like that for the Bombers supporters back at home who are tuning into Tats Thunder Vision tonight. Forget about that. Let's just focus on the future. And, well, you'd think you've got 40-odd minutes of football left. As the ball's back in the middle, tapped down that time there by Farrow, an inspired move to move him into that line as Sondergeld. Hand passes off. They get a quick kick away, heading in the Webster direction. Punched away from Tap, who has now ventured down back again from whence he came. Also, there is McEwen. It's tapped again there. That time there by Jason Rowe. Geez, they're working hard here. Redland to try and get it out. In the thick of the battle there, that time was McDonald. Heenan spent it before he had it. Oh, he went back in for some more, but he's not good with his pocket change today. As here come the Redland Bombers. Snapped on a sixpence, but it is through for a behind from Rees. This one point at a time momentum is not doing their fans any good on Tats Thunder Vision, territoryfc.com.au. It's great to have your company wherever you are watching around the world tonight. It's a bonus about being on the internet. Anyone can watch us anywhere, even in Antarctica. I'm still waiting to hear from anyone down there at the moment, as it is winter, so it's pitch black. So play on quickly, and it's Vassal along the wing, over the top, and here we go, Mr. Spreadable. Can he swoop onto this one? They're under pressure. Great work there by the Bombers. Gets a free kick for his trouble there in McDonald. In fact, it's Godfrey. He's on the outer side. So they try and chip it across, looking for a targeting Clouston a long way from home. Plays on quickly, trying to use it there that time through Thompson. Off to Salter. So Salter, looking for another option, goes down the line, and he's just made some more space for himself there in the likes of Thompson. They play on quickly, have to be good with the ball. Up goes Webster, and punch goes Tap. And it's seen over the boundary line, deep in the forward pocket there for the Redland Bombers.
Good old, we mentioned it at the call the other time, that one punch ability from Tap, bang, just gets to the contest every time. As the ball now is thrown in, opportunity here for the Bombers to snag a late goal. Clouston wins the tap down, an absolute bevy of players dive in, and Simon Walker says, I'll have it, let's go again. And just having a look there around the ball as we get eaten alive by mosquitoes here. Man. It's an outside broadcast at Palmerston. It's, so the umpire now bounces at Clouston and also Verncom go at it. One down by the former. Coming out to meet it though, sharking it nicely
Nice
and sticking it around the
good
ball. But
kick.
It's, wow, it's,
oh,
it's,
Sean.
But it's Sean Tapp saving the day for Thunder. They're away here and Bradley Vassal now can move Thunder back inside their attacking half. A few players calling for it in some space. He decides to go towards the other side of the ground. Nicely done by Verncom. Yeah. He ran hard there to create that sort of space. Now, what's he got up the line here?
Smith in the middle.
It's a scrubby looking kick. And Brady Finesmith in the air. Nicely done by the young fiddler. The weapon in Nathan Brown says, yes, I'll have a piece of that. They're out here. Willie Farrah can drive them inside. Look at the speed, the turn of pace that he has. Drives it up towards the forward line. One by two by Lock.
Anderson
could take it. Jed Anderson gets around one,
Spreadable.
Gets it over to Chris Spreadable, and he says, that'll do it. Thank you very much indeed. And it is, oh, hang on, no, there's a little bit of a conference call here.
Man.
The Bombers saying that it was touched, and no, in fact, it is a goal. The goal stands. So Thunder move along to 11-4-70, and the crowd says, thank goodness for that. And Redland 2-11-23. It's all happening here at Northline Oval in Palmerston.
How far away do you think the Northern Conference of the NEAFL are close to getting video referees?
A fair way off, I would say.
Well, you would think that anyway, but the amount of conferences that we're having out there, hey, look, we want the right decision.
Yeah,
that's what it's all about, getting the decision right. But my goodness gracious me, everyone having an opinion on it? My gosh. Yep. As the ball's back in the middle. Oh, it's helter-skelter stuff. We've sort of warmed ourselves up for a half, and now we're into the thrust of things here in the commentary box, and the players are doing likewise with the Thunder exploding into action. Cossack couldn't get rid of it in time, and he's been pinged for holding the ball. Here's a big chance through Bilski. He chips it across. Oh, that was a smart kick to Salter. Wasn't that a gorgeous kick? And Salter will line up from, well, roughly 20 metres out, slightest of angles, and... Well, you would hope for their fans that he could put this one through.
Yeah, look, at again, some great play there from the Bombers. Salter's been very, very good tonight for them indeed. He's presented well up the ground. He's provided a really good, strong set of hands, I should say, up forward. And he's got an opportunity here for a badly needed goal.
So Salter comes in. Nice looking kick off the boot. Straight as a die and much needed for him. He's had plenty of it tonight. One of their best. There's no doubt about that. About that, there is no doubt. And another score major on the board for... his boys in 3-11-29 to 11-4-70, and just making the most of the accuracy in front of goals, obviously. And also, the way that they did it then, they won the clearance, they went out wide, but then they came straight back in the guts. And in the first half, both teams were getting lost on the wings. We couldn't find them. We sent out SOS. We thought we found Amelia Earhart at one stage. I mean, that's how far away they were. It's ridiculous. But the ball's back in the middle. Willie Farrah, a standing jump, and he still wins the tap. But the clearance is won there by the Bombers. Hitting in the Clusen and tap direction.
Oh,
up goes Jason Rowe. In fact, it was Kevin Verncombe. So similar with the socks up and the nice-looking hairdo. Chipped over the top there of Matty Argus. He has to work hard to try and earn the ball back there that time. Salter working hard again, waiting for a whistle. Thought we heard it. No advantage played. Geez, they're working on their slip sketches today. I think it's Gully Fieldsman all over the place at the moment as Rosier shakes himself straight through the middle of a pack, heading in the Dunn direction, but a fine mark is taken. What a wonderful mark and strength taken there by Ewing. It is his home ground in the NTFL. The North Ballarat boy came up here only a couple of years ago, signed with the Magpies, one of the inaugural members of the NT Thunder. He's played the most games for the club. Let's see what Boof can do. That's his nickname. Bit of a character around the club, the number two. So Darren Ewing. Nice deliberate run-up. Good looking kick.
Oh,
and hits the post. Our first for the night. Bit of a difference from a couple of weeks ago where we had 13 in the end. But look, it's our first for the night. And, well, missed opportunity there for the Thunder to just dig the nails in even deeper into the Bombers.
So just over tick over 30 minutes gone here in this third term. Thunder leading at 11-5 to 3-11, a 42-point margin. Can the Bombers perhaps get one final thrust forwards here? Matty Rosier doing a little bit of calisthenics on jumping up and down on the mark. There he goes. But in the end, the Bombers try to work it away through Zufa. Comes back from whence it came. They're looking for the switch here, the Bombers. In fact, no, it's 1-2. Back over to you as Lockie Argus picking up Zufa once more. He's got Matty Thompson in a bit of space. He probably can't see him because it's that dark over there in that northwest corner. Nonetheless, he pumps it up the line. Verncombe and Clouston coming out to meet it. Beautifully taken in the end by Kevy Verncombe. He's had a standout night for Thunder. Great solid hands in that back line. Pumps them now up towards the centre-half forward line. Scrubby looking kick in the end. And he ends up finding the likes of Brad Howard. And now they're out. In fact, this is Howard. He's got Pringle. Once you pop, you can't stop. Just up the line. He instead goes further and instead goes back into the middle and finds Brad Rees just in front of the skipper there in Cammy Island. Where to from here? That's the next thing. There's closing up the line. And he goes in that direction. He might actually end up getting it in the end because it was a bit of a scrubby kick. He gets around tap very nicely indeed. Handballs over towards Cass. In there also is Mr. Spreadable. One down behind the Fonda. Great kick in the end going up the line and finds Jack McDonald. They worked it well there, the Bombers. Well played.
Still got no one up forward to really have a ping for. He's going to go in the Webster direction, but he's got to pierce four defenders. Oh. And Webster's ended up in it in the end. Amazing mark, Cameron Islett, Matty Argus, Willie Cossack, Patrick Heenan, all looking at each other going, how the hell did he do that? So young Webster has marked directly in front on the siren he will kick. And this is a much needed confident booster after the Thunder have absolutely gone wham bam, thank you man. We've got crowd on the ground, the little kids have gone berserk. Webster comes in.
Good finish.
Lovely looking kick. And right on three-quarter time, they get another one. That's their fourth for the evening. 4:11:35. They've been lambasted in that quarter. Absolutely so. And it's 11:5:71, the NT Thunder. A 31-minute quarter, a long one, mainly because of the goals that were kicked. But both sides working out the corridor football is the best way to go in this game. One quarter to go. And it looks like the NT Thunder could be taking home the minor premiership. But to find out more, you have to tune in shortly right here on Tats Thunder Vision.
Thank you for this great opportunity to build the ICTHIS LNG project in the Territory. That's why we're giving back to the community.
Students across Northern Australia now have access to more trade skills here in Darwin.
Oil and gas training and research are now available at our university because of this world-class project.
And more than 14 million has been injected into local roads.
We're committed to growing the Territory, so let's take this journey together.
ICTHIS, securing the future.
Authorised by ICTHIS LNG Proprietary Limited, Perth.
Palmerston Public Golf Course is a picturesque and challenging championship course, located just 16 minutes from Darwin CBD, at the very heart of Palmerston. The course features PGA qualified coaching and a fully equipped golf shop for all your golfing needs and custom club fittings. It's the perfect setting for a corporate day or a casual round, any day of the week. Palmerston Public Golf Course, at the very heart of Palmerston.
As soon as the bell went, it was like a herd, and they all came. You're going to record continuously all the way through this course. Okay? Yeah. so I can sync it up.
Hello and welcome back to Northline Oval. It's newly redeveloped. We've got the Chief Minister just to our left at the moment having a chat. And I tell you what, this is going to be one hell of a last quarter. We'll see if the Redland Bombers can bounce back. The Thunder just went absolutely berserk in that third quarter and kicked straight for a change, so to speak. They kicked 7 goals to 2. And it was just, yeah, a little bit lackluster, I should say. It's really just developed into a fierce contest in that third quarter where they're intent on the ball, the ferocity as well. Jack McEwen's been cited for charging. And hopefully we can see as many goals in that third quarter down this end, because that's what the fans have come here to see, free-flowing football. We didn't see much of it in the first, but I tell you what, the Thunder are all ready to go. Ed Callister and Josh Sampson joining you in commentary as the umpire blows the whistle, and away we go again for the last quarter. A nice-looking bounce that time, punched away there by Paxman. They're fired up, the Bombers, and they're eager to get a clearance out of it. Hands on knees sort of stuff. Has a quick kick away there that time by Lockwood. Heading in the Lachlan Argus direction. Tries to find Heenan. It slipped over at the crucial stage again. Ben Rioli under pressure. Matty Rosier has been everywhere tonight. A great tenacious tackle there by Matthew Rosier, and the ball will be bounced up just on centre wing. And all of a sudden, we're starting to get into the thrills and spills of Sunday chills. And as the ball is, well, thrown up. No, bounce this time. Tap down that time there by Tap, who's in the ruck work. He's been all over the place as well tonight, heading in the direction of Lockwood. Scooping on it there is Jed Anderson, putting it out there in front of the likes of Darren Ewing. Boone's in the area as well. He's held him well tonight, and it's punched away. Is it deliberate? And no, it won't be. He didn't really have anyone to tap it to, so to speak. But they do say that the defender's best friend is the boundary line. So the ball to be thrown in yet again. Deep in the forward pocket. Tapped down there by Lockwood. Play on, says the umpire, just looking for a free kick out of it. No, the umpire's going to throw it in again just because it was a little bit too short. So he comes in a little bit from the boundary line. A high arc on this one. Lockwood punches it away there that time from Kelly. Trying to swoop on it. Getting some space there is Dignan. They're rattling it up here. Tight on the boundary line and pushed over the boundary line. There is Bradley Vassell. And, well, they're closer to goal. It's safe to say that as the crowd is starting to mill and get excited about the crescendo of emotion at the end of this game and the way that this is travelling with the Thunder leading. Lockwood taps it over the top, looking for Dignan. Quick handball away that time. There was Godfrey. Tackled hard. Heenan's at the bottom of this one. Calling for holding the ball was some of the crowd. But away goes the likes of Salter on the outer side here for the Redland Bombers. Looking for some sort of an option. He hasn't really got anyone to kick to, so he hand passes to Rees instead. Linking up brilliantly, but putting his body on the line. There was the Thunder backman. Trying to get it forward yet again. It's just a hot potato sort of a football atmosphere at the moment. On the outer side, Webster hand passes away, trying to link up this time with Taylor, maybe a little bit high. Play on, says the umpire. Advantage is taken for an in the back over in the Argus direction. Salter working him over at the moment. Good work there by Salter, probably best on ground for the Bombers tonight. Plays on quickly, an errant handball, and it's seen over the boundary line in front of the scoreboard, which reads the Thunder 71 and the visitors, which are the Bombers 35.
So almost 3 minutes gone here in the final term here at Northline Oval in Palmerston, and they can taste it now, Thunder. They are one step closer to that Northern Conference Minor Premiership. Geez, tap going up for the ruck there. Working it away, a big booming kick from the captain in Cameron Islet. Lockwood comes out to meet it, so too does Anderson. Oh, shake break, sells a bit of candy. Stuff. Nicely done. Now he goes, a good searching kick for Willie Farrow, going for the jumping jack. The big fella in Darren Ewing dishes off to Paddy Heenan. He lines it up from about 15 metres out and says, thank you very much. The Chief Minister loves it. The crowd loves it as well. And Thunder move along to 12-5-7. They lead the Bombers 4-11-35. And some more of that champagne footy from the NT Thunder.
Free-flowing football, that's what it's all about. And that's what the Jet does best. Just hanging off the back just a little bit and then using his explosive power to make the most of the ascendancy that he has in those piston-like legs. I tell you what, it is brilliant football here at the moment by the NT Thunder. And we're a little bit worried about the lackadaisical sort of start from the Thunder. They, yet again, another slow start to a game. But they've worked themselves into it, and this is where they go so well. They are running a marathon now, and the season is starting to come to an end. Beautiful work there that time there by the likes of Vassell out in the Ewing direction. Good work by Boone to force a contact. Zufa punches it forward to Salter, linking up well now with Passfield. He's got a paddock to play with. Goes along the outer side, looking for the target in Clouston. Drops what he could have taken. Umpire said he wasn't interfered with, and away go the NT Thunder again, out in a paddock, and all on his lonesome is Matthew Argus. He's got so ample time to play with. He finds the weapon. He turns on a sixpence. He bombs it long. Pops it high in the Farrow direction. Doesn't take what he could have taken. He keeps it playing on quickly and just doesn't get the turn of speed there from the Sheriff in Lawler. And it's through for another behind. So a little bit of excitement starting to creep into the game. 78 plays, 35. The Thunder in control. They win tonight. They take out the minor premiership and get a bye next week in the first week of finals as Zufa kicks in. Trying to find a target. Vassell, well tackled. Here we go, another opportunity. The Sheriff, they're lining up. They're fluffed this one, the Thunder. McEwen lays on a Shepherd that time there on Taylor. Tries to get it out. They're under pressure, the Thunder. But they've done well, the Bombers, to link up. But where will they go to? Passfield goes along the wing. Looks for a target. Doesn't find the man intended for it there in Howard. Plays on quickly and the weapon. Tight on the boundary line. Looking for something. Lost his footing there. Players are slipping and sliding all over the place. It was like the Wet n Wild sort of theme park back in the day. Argus hemmed in on the boundary line and it's seen over on the full, or a free kick going the way of young Lachlan Argus after he was dealt with. Now this will be interesting, Josh, as you were down here at training earlier in the week. Is this an opportunity anyway? I mean, you look at the angle, he's pretty much balanced up. He's going to center it. Looks for Ewing. Taps it down, drags it down, and there's Mr. Spreadable. And he pushes it through for a behind.
So Chris Dunn just putting it the other side of the goals there. Just over 6 minutes gone. Here, a couple of balls in play. The umpire says, hang on a sec.
be entertaining.
No, it would.
Wouldn't it?
The circus is back in town here in Darwin, perhaps. As bringing back in there was Zufa, the former Brisbane Lion. He finds Adam Oxley, who's been a bit quiet tonight. For the Bombers, and foiling an unforced error there was Vassal. Picking up the crumbs was Kieran Smith. He throws it around the corner. Geez, the volleyball roots it back in town. And in the end, the mistake from Adam Boone is cleaned up by Julian Lockwood, and he's now thinking to himself, why did I do that? 14-7-91, the visitors in the Redland Bombers, 4-11-35. Geez, again, that comedy of errors is back.
Well, it's the decision-making that they're making in front of goals, whether it's in defence or whether it's in their forward line. They're not making the most of the opportunity. Darren Ewing's just saying a few words, just asking the question of young Boone, you know what, you've done a good job on me, but that was just silly. But it's just those little decision-making at the moment. You know, where they were kicked 1-8 in that first half, they had more of a chance to kick those goals. As the ball's back in the middle, tapped down there by Farrah. Thunder going for the jugular now. It's slipping and sliding again as players starting to lose their feet. Oh, it's a game of soccer at the moment as they're just, refusing point blankly to pick the ball up. Far on the outer side, deep in the forward pocket. They're a big chance here and a good mark. A great mark taken there by the big man. I think it's Reynolds. In fact, it's the number 11. And I think we might have had a blood rule a little bit earlier on, but I do think it's young Reynolds who has swapped his jumper over because of a blood rule. So the big fella comes on through. Lovely looking kick. It's a little bit straight.
He's got it.
It's a little bit right, and it's a little bit happy as the Bombers have kicked another one. And just trying to put some respect on the scoreboard now. 5-11 plays 13-7. It's the NT Thunder in control.
Yeah, they certainly are. But a good goal there again on the counter-attack from the Redland Bombers. Again, look, the opportunities that they have had tonight and obviously the scoring pressure that they've applied hasn't always been in the affirmative for them. But look, they need to finish off this game as strongly as they possibly can. It's not over for them. Of course, they'll take on the Gold Coast Suns in the elimination final next week. It's do or die for them. And it's certainly looking at this stage like it's a week off and a date perhaps with the Brisbane Lions or Southport for the NT Thunder. As the ball now is back in the middle, looks like Pryor and Paxman going at it. One down by Pryor, sharking his own ball nicely there was Pryor. Free kick's been picked out by the umpire. It'll go to Matty Rosier, who's had an excellent night for Thunder, it must be said. He says, come at me, and that's exactly what the weapon in Nathan Brown does. But geez, he asks a bit of him in the end. Oh, shakes one tackle, easily done. Up the line to Darren Ewing. It's just 1-2-3, counterpunch, sucker punch footy from Thunder. And Darren Ewing will line it up from around about 45 metres out on a tidy sort of angle. But he's a Palmerston boy. He knows how to get the job done here at Northline.
Darren Ewing, he's a big bulky sort of a lad, but extremely fit. In that Dane Swan sort of build, isn't he?
Yeah, he certainly is. So approaching here. It's Ed Callishaw says, kick it to me. He ends up kicking it into the man on the mark in Adam Boone. The weapon in Nathan Brown, dishing it out again. Lockie Argus around the corner. High looping kick. He's put it through. It's all coming up. NT Thunder here at Northline Oval. It's another goal there. And now they move along to 14-7-91. And he signals to the crowd, that was one for you. Almost 10 minutes gone. They lead Redland by 50 points, 5-11-41. And it's just all coming up gold for the NT Thunder.
I know Lachlan wants to play a little bit more up forward. Yep. He has been penciled in as a back pocket player by the coach. They think he's really good out of there, just mainly because he uses the ball so well and just because of his pace. But also, you do find players like Lachlan Argus, Ben Rioli, Patrick Heenan, who do float forward from the back half. They're defensive mids, but they're also attacking in the same sort of vein as another centre clearance heading in the weapon direction. Had his name all over this one, looking for options as Darren Ewing looks to make a lead. Chips it over, he's got to beat two. Punched away there by Zufa. Kept in play, just seen over the boundary line. And, well, just look for the likes of Willie Farrow to do something extravagant here in this latest part of this match. 10 minutes gone. The game's pretty much sewn up here by the NT Thunder. 91 plays 41, a 50-point lead at the moment. Both Ruckman absolutely missed that one. Good work there by the likes of Kelly to try and get a kick away. It's bouncing out in the Salter direction. He's had his name all over the leather tonight.
That's soft.
And a free kick downfield. And away they go. Josh Sampson might get fined for that comment.
Good.
as we go on forward into the Redlands forward 50 yet again. They had ample opportunities earlier on in tonight. In the second half, it's been few and far between. As they're waxing with the ball now, the NT Thunder, they go into the middle of the ground. The Sheriff needed to do more that time. Great work there by Passfield to keep it alive. They're off and running here. They need an opportunity here by the likes of Reynolds. He taps it forward this time, really trying to make a target for himself. He pops it up in the area of Clouston. Instead, he finds Pringle. And Pringle is marked only metres out. So it's junk time footy. And we've still got roughly about 15 minutes to go in this last quarter. But Pringle will line up. Going through the paces now on both sides. This is where the entertainment sometimes really does pop up. And yeah. Also at the same time, some random football that could be mistaken for that sort of game. So Pringle skips on in. Good looking kick.
He's missed.
The umpire has signalled it behind though. Jeez. Off the boot it looked okay. Unfortunately, it's through for another behind, and the Thunder will have a chance to work on their point-to-point kicking as they go quickly. Finds Jason Rowe. So Rowe on the outer side. Probably look to switch play yet again. As he goes up along the line instead, Verncombe using his body, tap, being a presence as always, plays on quickly, looks for Rosier, a quick kick heading in the Farrah direction, up he goes, tries to shake Oxley, he keeps his feet though, Farrah, and away they go. Oh, a turn of speed there from the big man in tap, that strength there by Ewing, he keeps it up, plays on quickly,
yes.
And dribbles it on through, Darren Ewing's up and about, getting himself into some form before the finals approach. Could have handballed off to Jed Anderson, but he thought, no, let's just get another one just to make sure that we look okay coming into finals. But geez, what an attacking forward line they have. Got goal scorers on every line, and over the last couple of weeks, Wolf's been pretty quiet, but he kicked six last week. He's got nearly a half a dozen here tonight. And yet again, there are just so many options up forward. Julian Lockwood can be a threat. Willie Farrah can be a threat. You even saw Sean Tapp come up here and be an option.
Yeah, that was his goal too.
Just so many opportunities.
So just over almost 13 and a half minutes gone here at Northline Oval in Palmerston. Well, he might be giving up his Ray Houston medal this year, Darren Ewing, but he doesn't mind still putting one through as the ball now. A nice shuck away there from the likes of Blake Passfield. A kick almost getting rain, almost one down there. Nicely done in the end was the likes of Clouston. And it looks like we have a shot from about 60 metres out. In fact, we do think it is Reynolds. There might have been a blood rule maybe at half time. But, geez, he's gone back a long way off the run-up too. But he approaches now around about 50 metres out. Kick on its way, floating, stays left for one behind. So 5-13-43, Redland move along to Thunder 15-7-97, 54 points the margin here at Northline Oval.
So the Thunder look to kick it in. Jason Rowe goes way up the back. What a mammoth of a kick that is, heading in the tap direction. But it's Vassell that puts his hand up for the mark. Play on, says the umpire. He's going to call it back. No advantage played on that one. And Vassell will take the kick as he just lifts himself up from the muddy surface that he's on. As he chips it across now, the Thunder looking for space. They find it there that time in Islet. He's got time to just get himself properly into a good position. Oh, geez, he goes through the hands that time there of the number 34 in Godfrey. Geez, they're just under pressure at the moment, Redland. And a free kick going the way of Matthew Argus. And this is the X factor that we were talking about, his tackling and his ferocity on the ball as he looks for an option. Just chips it across. Has to be a good kick for his brother in Lachlan. It goes over his head. Willie Farrah. Geez, he's got some space now as he taps it in front. Snaps it across his body, heading into the goal mouth. Boone has to work hard. He worm burns it, but it's trapped there by Lachlan Argus. He's trying to get it out. Geez, he's in the back, surely. And it is right in front of the crowd. And, I tell you what, just wouldn't be happy about that. Just has to turn. There is an art form to tackling, isn't there? It's that twist that you need to do just before they hit the turf. And, Lachlan Argus, a little bit better angle that we saw a little bit earlier on.
Yep.
As he had nothing to look of the goal mouth. So Lachlan Argus fancies himself. Just walks in. Oh, lovely looking kick off the boot. Has he got the right side of the post? He hasn't, and it's through for another behind. So it's point for point here so far in this last 5 minutes of this final quarter. Not near red time as such. Playing on is Zufa. He kicks it along the outer side, heading in the Verncombe region. Good work there by Farrah to try and trap it. McEwen's there as well. Running out of space there is Zondergild. And it will be thrown in 80 metres out. It's the Thunder leading 98 to Redland 43.
So 16 and a half minutes gone here. The boundary umpire, nice high looping boundary throw. And have a look at that. Tap coming over the top there was Verncombe. Geez, getting an absolute swarm of bombers coming in over the top to take Matty Rosier. And the umpire will come in and ball it up from whence it came. So I reckon that's probably the only thing we're missing tonight is we've had everything else, some great footy. How about a Willie Farrah Specky? Try saying that with a mouthful of marbles as McEwen now tries to win the ball back. Nicely done. Set upon there over the top was Jack McDonald. The Bombers players one holding the ball. They don't get it. And umpire Simon Walker will ball it up again. So a fair bit to think about for the young man in Jack McEwen going up potentially before the NEAFL tribunal. The ball now is bounced. The rucks go out. A nice tap over the top there from Paxman. Geez, a dinky little handball over the top. He gets it back in the end was Kieran Smith. Grubbers the ball up towards Willie Farrah, who comes out to meet it. Can he maintain his feet and maintain possession? He can. Good outside
here
handball to Julian Lockwood. The chip for Mr. Spreadable. He's overcooked it in the end. And the ball's come over way from Adam Oxley. Now the Bombers have got some space, but what have they got up ahead here? It's Blake Passfield with the ball, trying to get into some of that space now. Some long leads being made. The umpire's going to hurry him on here, and he does. So he decides to go to the scoreboard side of the ground. Jaden Pryor did well to make the contest in the end. And it looks as though Jason Rowe will see it over, and he does. Centre wing on the outer side, the schoolyard side of the ground here at Northline Oval.
Only a few minutes away from time on. Both sides just going through the paces as the Stings out of this one. 7-3. Third term really putting the nail in the coffin for the Redland Bombers tonight. Trying to bust his way through the pack there that time is Hunter. He's all wrapped up and will be thrown up yet again. So a really good evening here in Palmerston. The first ever Thunder match being played out here at Northline Oval. New refurbished facilities. And the crowd have had a really enjoyable night as the Thunder make another forward thrust. Tapped out there that time by the likes of McDonald, trying to get it forward yet again. Plenty of players around this spillage. Well, a throw has been pinged on that one. Jeez, and Reynolds is not too happy about it either, and I'd totally agree with him as Lachlan Argus ends up with the ball in front of Oxley on the outer side. He pops it up and just trying to shepherd the player off. Is Willie Farrah's Chris Dunmark, so Mr. Spreadable himself earned the nickname after covering himself completely with Nutella at a player function earlier on in the season. He won the award for best dressed.
Well, I don't know how, because he wasn't really wearing a hell of a lot and he was in public, so
lucky the Nutella is in the right spots at the right time. So Mr. Spreadable comes on in. Oh, geez, there's a wobbly sort of a kick. Lockwood marks on the last line of attack, and he kicks another one. Julian Lockwood in the right space at the right time. He's the only one that judged that awful-looking kick by Mr. Spreadable, but hey, nonetheless, he's got a goal for his troubles. He's kicked a couple in this last quarter.
Yeah, he's been good.
And, he's really come into his own after he filled in for Jason Rowe earlier on in the season at full back. Then he had to go up forward a week later, kicked a couple. He's a utility, and look, he does look like a wounded warrior with all the bandages that he has on his body, but I tell you what, he's up and about, the big fella, and interesting to know that majority of the side are aged under 23 years of age, so plenty of talent still to come.
So Reynolds now wins it down for the Bombers, but it's Kieran Smith who comes away, but he's had a very, very good second half. A bit of a torpy. The old torpy comes back into it. Dunn couldn't get it, but in the end, it was the likes of Sam Godfrey who could. Pumps it up towards centre-half forward. Duncan can't take the mark. Trying to shark it on the outer side there is the likes of Zane Pringle. He goes sideways, and he ends up finding Brad Rees. That's a nice kick kick over the top there, and it might have even come back to Zane Pringle from whence it came. Good hard running there by the Bombers, and they've got an opportunity to put through their sixth goal for the night.
They've done that well, Redland, and they've looked good at times tonight.
Yeah,
there's no doubt about it. Their first half was sublime with the way that they were dominating the stoppages and the clearances. They just couldn't put the score on the board. Let's see if they can add another major.
In fact, it's James Webster with the ball. He's about 45 metres out. Kick on its way. Doesn't look too bad off the boot, but it's just a bit to the left. So 5:15:45. It's been a dirty night in front of goals for the Redland Bombers. They trail the NT Thunder 16-8-104, almost 21 and a half minutes gone in this final term.
Can you see Redland playing the Thunder again this season?
I don't think so, no. Not on what we've seen tonight.
So as the ball goes high and straight up the guts yet again, Bryle was on hands and knees. He ended up with it anyway. Patrick Keenan bombs it inside the forward 50, looking for his mate and partner in crime, and Willie Farrer, as he's playing volleyball and spiking it wherever it comes. Pryor busts his gut through the middle. Farrer ends up with it. Does he put a lace out through for another one?
He does.
You bet your dollar he does. Willie Farrer's popped through another one tonight. Another multiple goals kicker for the NT Thunder. And they just keep on keeping on here at Northline Oval. 17-8-110 to 5-14-44.
Jaden Pryor, take your hat off. That was your goal, son. They managed to burst his way through a couple of would-be Redland Bombers tacklers. And as seems to be the case, as usual, you get the 1% out, you go off for a spell. But yeah, look, Thunder really starting to open this up now. And look, they didn't need the percentage, but they're getting it nonetheless. So
how old do you need to be when you start calling football players son? Just because our age bracket is not too dissimilar of the players. So I get concerned when, you know, are there anyone in Adelaide that's got some young kids?
I don't know, as Chris Dunn comes in. 20 metres out, it's another one. And it's party time here in Palmerston as I try to forget about... Maybe there's some dependents. You know that question, do you have any dependents? I usually say not that I know of, but you just never know. 18-8, 116, a very quick answering goal there from Thunder. They lead Redland 5-14-44, 23 gone here at Northline Oval.
Yeah, we're into red time, and as we ponder the question of young children in Adelaide for Josh Sampson, well, I think it's just a legitimate question, you know, and I'm sure people are thinking back home, you know, how old are these commentators that are calling? Well, we're not that old. And if we're calling players son, we've got some issues, I think. As the ball makes its way back into the middle and has bounced yet again, Reynolds doing the ruck work. Tap down there, that time there by Tap. He did a good job getting it out into the Argus direction. Had to work hard there with Stout Milkins. He's been pretty quiet tonight. Rosier, he's probably been the best for Thunder, you would think, just with his attack on the ball. And they're under pressure yet again. Here comes Julian Lockwood. Geez, he's working well, big foot,
well,
isn't
done.
He? Gosh, he's done very, very well to trap it up. He took on three players. And really did earn it. Well, a free kick has gone against him, but he just did well just to hold it up. And they're going to get the ball back anyway, the NT Thunder, as they slow things up through Smith, out to Dignan into the middle of the ground. Always a hard worker. He goes laterally to find Mr. Spreadle. So Chris Dunn is marked. Leeds are starting to open up. Chipped across to Willie Farrer. Is that 15? I don't know. You know, you always get worried when someone goes up for a mark and lands from where the guy kicked it. So Willie Farrer, directly in front, looking to add another one to his tally. And geez, he's been a weapon this year. A really, really good player, and definitely going to be one up there for the best and fairest as he pops one up through the middle yet again. They're on song, the NT Thunder. And really blowing this game out of control. 19-8-122 to 5-14-44. Geez, the way it was set up brilliantly there by Jake Dignan with that cross kick across there to Mr. Dunn. He just chipped it across, and easy as you like, as I always say, to just pop it through the middle. And just the way that they've kicked straight, they've been working on their goal kicking over the last 5 or 6 weeks because they know it's going to be important come finals, and they've done the job tonight.
They certainly have. Geez, Chris Dunn, hasn't he had it on a string in this last quarter?
Yeah.
Everywhere the ball goes, he's like a magnet. As Tap now wins it down for Thunder. Geez, they're really starting to go in for the kill. Lockwood gets the handball away over towards Rosier. Good tackling pressure to hold it up. Bursting his way through there was Lockwood once again. Beset upon there was Matthew Argus. Good tackle from the skipper in Cameron Isle to hold proceedings up, and the ball will be bounced up just next to the centre circle. Almost 26 minutes gone here in this last quarter. It's been great having your company tonight on Tats Sun Division, the home of Territory Football. And just you wait, because we're going to be back for some more in the next couple of weeks. A scrubby old handball there. Rosier winning down his own ball, but a quick snap away there from Passfield, and now they've got a chance to go forward here. Coming out to meet it beautifully there was the likes in the end of Webster, who handballs over the top in the end to Tyler Jones. A long pumping kick. This is going to test Benny Rioli, but in the end he's got some help there from his mate in Willie Cossack. He goes this way, that away, and now they've got numbers here on the outer side of the ground. Oh, Paddy Heenan putting down what he should have taken. Then Vernkem is on here, and he's got Jake Dignan in a little bit of support escorting him. He can go there if he wants. He tries to draw the player, sells a bit of candy. Dizzy asked a bit much of Dignan in the end, but a great tackle to hold it up, and they can work it away here now. Zufa for the Bombers. Jeez, they're on here. Look at the space they've got. In the end, going up the line. Oh, good spall there in the end was the likes of Benny Rioli, and it's sent through for a rush behind. Well, again, at a 4-on-1 situation, the Bombers, they didn't take the most of it. 5-16-46, they trail Thunder 19-8-122.
It's those little mistakes that they make just in front of goal that really do cost them opportunities, as Webster kicked it off the ground for a behind. But here comes Jason Rowe, a big, long, booming kick in the Verncombe direction. Had to be three, got a push out, and will get a free kick for his cause. So we just wait for the ball to come back into play as players go into their spots on the ground. Not long to go, you would think, in this last quarter. As the Thunder are in full control, 122-45. They play on quickly. Good work there by Isla to chip it across, finds Pryor. He trapped it in the end. The Big Bear is in a little bit of bother as he pops it up in the Dignan direction. Lachlan Argus will trap this, but he's under pressure from Zufa. He misjudged both of them at the moment. Anderson putting pressure on the ball. He'll end up with it. A gorgeous pickup. Tries to create some space. Gets back on his left. A worm-burning kick to Farah. He's in a bit of bother. Ewing's there as well. On hands and knees, doing the hard work. Argus is there as well. Another tough tackle there by Matthew Argus, asking the question. Took on two of them and ended up winning. And what a wonderful work there by all players concerned there, with Reynolds and also Boone as well. Metres out from the attacking goal for the NT Thunder as Boone and Ewing head back to their sparring corners. Reynolds taps it down. No one really won it out that time. Going in hard is Lockwood. Puts a knee in. No one really noticed it except myself. And the ball will be thrown up yet again. So right in front of our commentary position, in front of this wonderful grandstand being put up only over the last couple of months. First ever game for the Thunder here at Northline, and they've done it with aplomb tonight. Tap down. Oh, a little bit of ball to Nick Davis sort of stuff there by the NT Thunder. But neither of those players are playing tonight. Busting it out there is Matthew Argus. Gets it on a check side is Anderson. Oh, Farah trying to tap it forward. It goes back from whence it came. Islet's all over this one as well. Going in hard is Rees, and also there is Thompson. Toe poke sort of kick. Argus looking for some sort of help. Off to the Sheriff in Lawler. He's under pressure. Gets it back to the weapon. Pops it up high and through for a behind. That's one of the most exciting points you'll see all season, I think.
Yeah, I would say so. It's a long, long behind.
123 plays 46.
29 and a quarter minutes gone here. Not too long now before the Palmerston party starts for the NT Thunder. They're going to take out the minor premiership in a big attempt there at a wobbly old torpedo punt. Just managing to get inside 50. Great handball there to find Tyler Jones in the end. He's going to ask a lot here of Jason Rowe. In fact, no, he's not, because he ends up winning the ball back for Thunder. He's got the skipper in, Cameron Island, up the line. Can he get him? There's the siren. It made us not, but the NT Thunder, after slow starts, after the hoodoo in Alice Springs, after some challenges from many, many very good sides, they have taken out the minor premiership in the NEAFL Northern Conference. 19-9-123, defeating Redland 5-16-46. Thunder go through to the second semi-final, where they'll play the winner of the Brisbane Lions and Southport, while for the Bombers next week, it is a do-or-die clash against the Gold Coast Suns in the elimination final.
Well, this time last year, I'm unsure whether they will be playing the Gold Coast Suns or not, just because of the points difference there. You see, Gold Coast got done pretty thoroughly, and Labrador, if they got the win, they're on equal points there with the Gold Coast. They might have slipped up into that top five position, so we'll just wait on the actual facts on that one until it comes to hand. But we do know who's going to be playing off in the qualifying final, and that will be Brisbane Lions and Southport after what happened earlier today with Brisbane losing. But Brisbane have maintained the rage all season. They've been sitting on top of the ladder, and now they're starting to fall away. a lot was made of the NT Thunder and the makeup of the side at the start of the season. Have they gone too small? Do they have enough height? Their bigs, they're injured throughout most of the season. They're now starting to work themselves back into finals contention. I talk about Jason Rowe, I talk about Sean Tapp.
Yep.
Josh Chaplin is another one who could probably fit into this side. Kenrick Tyrrell is another one who can come into this side. So they've got plenty of tall timber to really muscle up coming into finals and mixing it with the bigger sides, yep, such as the Brisbane Lions and the Southport Sharks. It's an amazing situation. Daniel Archer came into the lineup. We had a new coach. We had a new CEO. Everything had changed. We had a turnover around about 20 players this season.
Yep.
And also the fact that all these players have come from different parts of the territory. We've got 10 based in Alice Springs, Hermansburg, Catherine, Wadare, Jabiroo and the likes. It's an amazing sort of system. And if you are listening out there and you do get a chance to see a documentary called Northern Lights, you'll actually see the behind the scenes of what the actual NT Thunder Football Club is about. Now, obviously what they do on the field is what they do well, and that's win games, yep, at the moment. But a lot of work goes out of spreading the game of football in the Northern Territory. And I do recommend anyone that does get their hands on a copy of Northern Lights, please give the club a call or click on the website for more information, territoryfc.com.au. In the meantime, we talk finals. The NT Thunder, are they beatable? This is 11 in a row. Do you get nervous about a situation where should they have lost a game on the way to finals? A lot of people say it's nice to lose one just before finals to know, hey, keeps the hunger alive.
Well, I spoke about this on my radio program on Territory FM this morning, and this is always a contentious one because, you know, there is that theory. Some people believe that you do need to lose one to eventually win the ultimate prize. I'm totally against that theory. I think if you're playing good footy, if you're playing good contested footy, if you've got a wide range of players in good form and who can slot back into the lineup like Territory Thunder have got, as they get a standing ovation from the folks here in Palmerston, it doesn't matter how many games you've won. You don't have to be the best side all season, just the best side when it counts, and I do agree with that. But I think the way that Thunder is placed, the expectation that they have on themselves, the pressure they put on themselves to perform, and the way that Daniel Archer has brought this group together, considering that they've turned the list over, he has done an absolutely magnificent job. And look, ultimately they will be judged on how they perform in August/September. But no, look, all they need to do now is keep winning. They're potentially two wins away from a premiership now. You know, I don't see the reason to have this idea of having to drop one.
What about having the week off? We saw what it did to the Nightcliffe Tigers in the NTFL earlier this year, and it probably cost them a little bit of momentum. A lot of people say that sometimes the rest can be a good thing or a bad thing. It's a 50-50 way of looking at things. Do we have that sort of situation with Thunder? It didn't seem to worry them last year, but that was a different team.
Yeah, it was a different team. I tend to think that it's probably not going to worry them too much having the week off. They're a very, very fit group, and the high-performance staff have got to take a lot of credit for that, the way that they've developed this group and kept them out on the park. And look, Kenny Tyrrell to come back in, hopefully for the second semi-final, he'll be champing at the bit. He will be an angry man because he's not able to get out there. That's what he loves. He's a competitor. But no, look, the Thunder list is in pretty good condition. There's competition for spots. Cameron Island's been outstanding as their captain. All of their good players are in form. I think the week off in Thunder's case this time around is probably coming at the right time, just for them to take a breather and to go again and really give the finals a really decent shake.
I think the other interesting thing is that we saw them against Southport a couple of weeks ago and they got the job done by about 40 points, but we haven't seen what the lineup of the Brisbane Lions will do, whether they will rest their key AFL link players. And the reason why I say rest them is because we mentioned and alluded to before this call got underway tonight, as the Thunder boys get clapped off here tonight.
Yeah, great.
After a wonderful performance, 123-45 in the end. We just talk about the Brisbane Lions and whether they'll have a full crack at a NEAFL premiership, whether Voss wants to go that way or he'll pull out all his senior players and get them all ready for a solid pre-season and another crack at it with AFL next year. That's the question that we've got to worry about with the Brisbane Lions. At this stage, you'd have to say the Thunder are red-hot favourites going into it, but it's a funny game, football.
Yeah.
You don't know who's going to turn up on each day. We saw how they've customised themselves to this ground. We see Redland going through their debrief, still on the ground here tonight. it'll be interesting to see how far they go into it. They could be playing Labrador or Gold Coast. They get a home final next week, so that's the bonus for the Redland Bombers. Yep. But at the same time, they just need to make the most of their opportunities in front of goal. They had their chance to really put scoreboard pressure on the NT Thunder tonight, and they just didn't do so. Final score lines here tonight as they just start to disappear. 123-45, and a wonderful performance by the NT Thunder. We'll be back in a couple of weeks' time. We won't be back next week because we've got the bye. But we'll be back here at Northline Oval in a couple of weeks' time. We look forward to having your company. My name's Ed Cowlishaw. Josh Sampson is my left-hand man, and we'll be back on Tats Thunder Vision. Can't wait to have your company for the second semi-final.